And it's Danny Kingad in the red trunks, Muhammad Haider in the black trunks.
Kingad's got an unconventional stance. He's keeping his left hand very low. He has a almost erratic footwork that he's debuting here. So he's really, I think the nerves might be a little bit, this is a big stage for him to be on right now, but he's so excited and he's so pumped to be here tonight. Kingad, on the other hand, looks very composed, relaxed, stalking forward, just kind of controlling the center of that cage.
Certainly a controlled start, as you say. Not much action yet, both very, very cautious, not wanting to make an error, and it's no surprise that Olivier Cost asks them to step up the pace a little bit, and they respond straight away.
See, Steve, there's that crushing leg kick that Kingad likes to throw. You typically see the Wushu fighters from Team Lakai throwing that push kick. He likes to change it up and attack the legs. Nice double leg takedown by Kingad right there as he puts Haider on his back, but he pops right back up and he goes right back down.
Heavy takedowns as well. The whole cage seemed to vibrate. Really have got a noisy crowd here, even in the early part of the evening.
Yeah, Kingad's real popular with the Filipino fans.
Any fighter that comes from the famed Team Lakai really kind of takes on the weight of the nation on their shoulders, and they support that weight very well indeed.
You can see Muhammad Haider trying to slide out, but right now the fighters are dry. They haven't worked up a sweat yet, so it's really easy just to kind of hold on to your opponent and control them. So you really have to demonstrate really good technique in these early stages of this round where everybody is so fresh and so strong.
Olivier Cost will be on top of Danny Kingad to make sure he works to some kind of a finish. At the moment, he's using his elbows and his forearm to try and create some damage.
See, Kingad just got easily let, you know, slide up on the top, and he's just dropping the punches down on top.
And
really
it's not
going to
last much longer, Mitch. That's it. You could see that Muhammad Haider was intent only on covering up. There was no way he was going to throw any punches back from that position. And Danny Kingad improves his mixed martial arts record in front of his home fans. No better way to do it, is there?
Nice little entry here as Kingad slides in for the double leg, picks him up, sends him for the ride, and it looks like Haider just kind of holds on, so Kingad picks him up again and puts him back down on his back. And that was just the beginning of the end for Muhammad Haider.
Great performance from the Filipino in front of his home fans. Rich Franklin's alongside me. Rich, this arena filling up quickly, and they're a noisy bunch, aren't they?
I'll tell you what, anytime we come to Manila, it's just amazing how noisy the fans are here. They love their MMA in the Philippines.
They really do. They're really knowledgeable as well. But we've got so many great Filipino fighters who are young, and athletic. Here's Anthony Suntay.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Cost calls a halt to this battle. At 2 minutes, 20 seconds of round number one, for your winner, via referee stoppage due to strikes, Danny Kingad!
Tokera has 7 TKOs on his record, so a very dangerous man. Kingad may well be unbeaten, but by far the more inexperienced of the two fighters, and this means that if Kingad can get the W here, it's a big stepping stone for him.
Ooh, that was a beautiful transition. Tokero went after the leg after catching the kick, and Kingad was able to roll it and use the caught leg to end up with the look. It looked like he threw him with his leg.
It was extremely unorthodox and
that
high pace.
Beautiful. Rich Franklin looks baffled next to me. He has no idea what that was. Something out of a kung fu movie. Beautifully done. Kingad on top now, trying to slide past the half guard a little bit, but just inching Tokero up against the cage there, possibly looking to dish out some ground and pound. Steps over, looks like he's trying to get into mount. Looks like it could be a guillotine setting up there. The Team Lakai fighters have spent so much time improving their wrestling and their grappling game, and we've seen it. And they've just grown by leaps and bounds. Every time these fighters get into the cage, they're showing an improved skill set.
They've had an absolutely tremendous 2016, and it's ended up with Edward Folayang as the lightweight champion. It started with Kevin Belling on losing his tilt at Bibiano Fernandez, but it's ended so well for them. Folayang beating Shinya Aoki, giving everyone, not just Filipinos, but everyone, that realization that no matter how much of an underdog you are, there's always a chance if you get your game plan right and execute your skills perfectly on the night.
Half guard shown here by Tokero, and he's really got to try to get away from having his back flat against the mat there. Kingad's doing the right thing by pressuring him like that and also keeping his head on that side of the body so Tokero can't turn onto his side and start maybe shrimping away out of that. See, he's got the pressure on the hip from the legs, then he's got the head pressure and the shoulder pressure pinning Tokero in that position. Tokero wants to start to shrimp out and move his back towards the center of the cage and possibly start to get out of this position, because Kingad's doing a little bit of damage here. He's landing some strikes. Kingad's trying to push down on that knee so he can pass the knee through the leg gap there to end up in a mounted position.
Very limited with what he can do with that left leg. Tokero's constantly trying to wrap his legs around that, although he's escaped it now.
Now he's got side control now.
Elbows to the body from Kingad. 21 years old.
Yeah, we've seen so many fighters here tonight that are just starting their MMA career, and really their potential is just, it has no bounds to see how good these kids can get, especially when you have training partners like Bonario, like, you know, the champion Folayang, you know, Kevin Belagong. You have so much talent around there up in Team Lakai that these kids are so young, they're just gonna grow every single time they get in the cage. And fighting a guy, the experience of Tokero is only gonna add to Danny's overall game.
And I've seen those guys run up and down the hills in Baguio. No wonder they've got such huge quads and tremendous stamina.
Watch out, headbutt, watch out.
The stamina, training and elevation up there in Baguio is just gonna do so much for your capability when it comes to the conditioning aspect, to grind out these fights and to push these fights into deep water. You gotta bet that they're gonna have the advantage. Good ground control shown by Kingad here. He's transitioned into an armbar.
Oh, and looks good, he's tapped straight away. So Kingad wasn't having any of that. He hurt his arm quite badly there. Edward Folayang jumps into the cage and lifts young Danny Kingad up above him. He improves his record to 4-0, and suddenly your eyes are opened at this young man, whose unbeaten record is now at a fairly significant number. Just 21 years old, remember, and he's beaten in Eugene Tokero, a man who is well known in this cage, and that was an instant submission, Mitch.
Oh, that was beautifully done. He was able to lock in that arm, slide around, transition into it, a beautiful armbar submission.
Wonderful exhibition from young Danny Kingad, and Team Lakai's incredible year goes from strength to yet more strength. Tokero falls to 8-4.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee Olivier Coste has put a stop to this fight after 4 minutes and 26 seconds in the first round. For your winner by way of armbar submission, Danny Kingad.
But probably the biggest problem is the man facing him. Mohammed Ayman has skills. He has speed and athleticism. Great emotion and passion, as you saw earlier on as well.
We've got, again, Bali MMA against Team Lakai. Two powerhouses out here in the Asian region.
A lot of people pick this one out as one of the great matchups of the night.
Ooh, nice left hand from Kingad.
He's got some speed, isn't he?
Yeah,
a little bit
he
of
does.
Ferocity. Whoa!
talk about speed. That counter right hand from Muhammad Aima was blinding. You can already see that these two are really up for this. Keep your eyes on it.
Now that was a kick.
Sounded low.
I think there was a lot of upper left thigh in that, but I'm not disputing that there was some central connection, and that means that there's a little bit of trouble.
The skin and the cup sound completely different. I think that was a little bit of both.
Ladies and gentlemen, injury time. The fighter has 5 minutes.
And
yeah.
The top.
Clearly below the belt. Not in the horrific area, but as you can see there, every fighter adjudged to have been the recipient of a foul kick is allowed 5 minutes for a medical examination and recovery. And Brandon, that's valuable, isn't it?
Both of these guys, yes, sir. You need that time to get your brains back together and get back into the fight.
And it looks like we're cut well inside the 5 minutes that's allowed. And these two get back to work.
Kingad's keeping that right hand nice and high, protecting his guard, but also getting ready to fire.
It looked like there was a little clash of heads there for a moment, but look at the speed these two are exhibiting when they're in the pocket. Oh, tremendous knee to the midriff from Kingad and a left hand there. These two are moving at tremendous pace.
Kingad able to drag the fight to the ground. Now he's in side control here. Mohamed Aiman's trying to get back into guard, does a nice job of getting that knee through and kind of stopping Kingad from getting into full side control. He's able to see how he's keeping that knee nice and tight to the body of Kingad, and he's just kind of moving with him. As Kingad tries to pass into side control, Aiman's doing the right thing.
Both of these two are fantastic. Well, they have tremendous futures in front of them, so to see them meet each other so early in terms of their age is a fascinating one.
Oh, transitions right into mount. Now he's got that high mount position, dropping some elbows. Aiman's gonna try to scoot out the back, but good pressure from Kingad.
Flush on the face, those elbows, didn't they? Very damaging indeed. He's trying again, but that was more with the forearm. And there's the elbow to the temple.
It's more than just the shorts and the Team Lakai logo. This guy looks very similar to our champion, Edward Foliang, who we're gonna see later tonight defend his title.
Knees to the head, and Aiman is taking a lot of punishment in that area now from forearms and elbows and knees. This is not where he wants to be. He does his best work on his feet with those tremendously quick hands of his.
He's keeping the hand nice and tight. Trying to pin down the arm. Now he's got in the crucifix position. This is a bad spot for Aiman to be in. He's got to create some movement.
The crucifix position and the crowd behind him. And now the back of Muhammad Aiman. No immediate danger there with that arm around the throat, but he's tossed down.
Big takedown. This kid has some very innovative takedowns.
But he's a strong boy, isn't he? There's quite a difference in torso between these two.
The core strength of Kingad to throw people around the way that he does is extremely impressive. Kingad's top control is something special. He's able to just smother his opponents and just drop in ground and pound on him. Aiman's trying to walk the cage, trying to circle out. Might be able to escape out the back door, but Kingad's got a pretty tight grip on him. Here looks to be, he doesn't have the arm in. Might be threatening an inverted triangle possibly there, but Kingad just staying in north and south. Dropping some knees down. He's got a few submissions from here. There are a few chokes. He could possibly lock up a Kimura, but this is Kingad's specialty. He likes the ground and pound. He likes to manhandle his opponents and drop shots on them.
Final 15 seconds of this opening round. It's been an absolute thriller.
Good job by Aiman to get back up to his feet and to finish his round. Standing in the middle of the cage as they exchange heavy shots.
What a round that was. Five furious minutes, and the crowd, I'm sure, cannot wait to get into the second round.
Here we go. That was a nice left hand by Kingad. Aimon tried to get up on top, but Kingad was just able to muscle his way on top. And that's where the round was pretty much dictated. He was able to get into side control, drop heavy ground and pound. Let's go to our guest judge, the world heavyweight champion, Brandon Vera, to get his input on that round.
Were very, very aggressive. The biggest difference between both of them was the ground control of Kingad. He was on the ground controlling the whole time, dropping elbows and knees to the head while holding him down and side control. Biggest difference, first round aggression. Let's see it this second round.
What a prospect. More time with these two in the cage. I love the first 5 minutes. Danny Kingad against Muhammad Aiman. The Philippines against Malaysia on this noisy night, this action-packed, atmospheric evening at the Mall of Asia Arena.
Aiman immediately starts pushing forward. Knows he might be in a slight bit of a hole from that first round. So he's trying to get back into it by pushing forward, and see how he's controlling the cage. Now, Kingad's got to get his back away from the cage, kind of staying stationary, but he immediately circles out. Good footwork from Danny Kingad.
Figures that Aiman has to really concentrate now. He's got to do his best work when he's standing up here. That's where he is really impressive. Kingad seems to be the stronger of the two on the deck, and that's where he wants to put this fight right now.
Kingad slides under the punches to shoot in for the double, transitions to a single. Now he's starting to suck the hips away from the cage because Aiman's going to want to start to stand back up. So Kingad's going to slowly start to pull the hips away from the cage so Aiman can't pop back up. Now he's starting to turn the corner. Good cage control from Danny Kingad. Ooh, nice step over there from Danny Kingad. Aiman had half guard, but Kingad was able to step out. Now he's trying to slide the knee back in across the stomach of Kingad. Now he's got a high guard. Kingad's just smothering him, though. Aiman's not able to just get anything moving. He can't create any kind of scrambles. Kingad's got to be one of the stronger guys at this weight. Team Lakai is known for their unique strength and conditioning programs. They like to throw bricks around, carry bales of hay, jumping over cars.
Elbow to the side of Muhammad Aiman's head.
See, now he's got an inverted triangle here. See how he's one arm is inside?
Yeah.
And he's got, there's a submission here, but Kingad's trying, looks like he's trying to muscle out of it.
He's gonna use those strong legs to lift himself up if he can, but he's locked in there, isn't he?
That's a bad position for Danny Kingad to be in, because Aiman could hold this for probably a couple of minutes, but he's not really on top. Oh, look at Kingad muscling his way out, but he readjusts, but he's got to kind of pop his hips over to the side so he can get a little bit deeper into that triangle.
Jammed up against the cage wall. Yuji Shimada tells Muhammad Aiman not to grip the wall with his toes.
Work to finish.
Work to finish, he also says.
Aiman has a very bad position on an Americana-type grip there on his arm. You can see the arms are interlaced, and it's kind of bending. I mean, he has the possibility to crank his Kingad's right arm out, but look at that muscle just
And suddenly the forearms come down, and then more heavy blows. Aiman's taken quite a bit of punishment in that area from that source.
Wow, look at the strength of Danny Kingad. Pops the head. Now he has got head control, presses that shoulder into the chin there of Muhammad Aiman. That was a good hip. He tried to bridge out, create a little bit of space. He's trying to turn. Nice and tight from Danny Kingad. He's trying to possibly lace in a darce choke here. Yep, that's what he's looking for. Darce choke. Now he's got, see, once he gets that hand across the bicep, that's a bad spot for Muhammad Aiman.
This crowd roaring their encouragement.
head out.
Directly above us here at cage side, knees to the chest from Kingad, oohs and ahs from the crowd here at cage side as we enter the final minute of the second round, a three-round contest, 15 minutes for these two to impress the judges or finish it early. And now Ayman has Kingad's back. What can he do with it?
Well, Hyman Ayman is a little bit high, and Kingad's trying to drop his hips down. He could possibly do it. He could take him down, or he could just jump onto the back of Danny Kingad. Almost a takedown, almost a sacrifice takedown to end up on top.
Every move is being greeted by this audience with oohs and ahs.
But the difference is the strength of Danny Kingad. He's able to just out-muscle all the positions that Muhammad Ayman's trying to get into.
He's got that thick, muscular upper body, hasn't he? And he's working to his advantage here. We're about the end of the second round. 10 minutes down, five to go, potentially.
Wow, impressive round there for Danny Kingad to end the round on top. Here's that Americana that was trying to be attempted, but just kind of a lost cause there. Kingad able to drop in some elbows. Let's go to the ONE World Champion, Brandon Vera, for his take on that round.
More from the same from Kingad. He's been controlling him on the ground, throwing knees, throwing elbows, just punishing Ayman on the ground. He's winning first and second round on ground control with strikes. It's amazing to watch this guy work, and his strength, his tenacity is awesome. Those boys at Team Lakai don't play around.
Brandon, does Muhammad Ayman have a shot?
He has to stay on the feet. He has to keep it on his feet if he wants a chance to win this fight.
There you have it, Steve.
Every round starts on the feet, and that will be to Muhammad Ayman's advantage initially. How long will that status survive, though? That's the question. How long before he gets dragged down into the swamp, into the sinking sand that Kingad provides?
Let's go fight out.
Both fighters looking really fresh here in the final round. Like Brandon Vera said, Ayman's got to keep this fight on his feet, so he might want to not push forward that intense pressure that he's had in the first two rounds. He's really got to create his distance, some lateral movement to keep moving. And punching may be his best weapon here, because he throws those kicks. Kingad might catch the kick, take him down.
Spinning back fist.
You know, this, or trying something really fancy to expose him to a possible takedown.
I'm just thinking the pace of this fight. And here they are at the beginning of the third round, still looking very, very fresh. The weight-cutting experience at ONE Championship, which incorporates hydration very importantly, means that they are fresh as they possibly can be here. And that's why we're seeing high-quality mixed martial arts right through to the end of the 15th minute.
To have zero fighters dehydrated, I mean, it changes the game completely. If you don't have to worry about cutting weight, you can just focus on your best performance ever, it creates an entirely different game.
Kingad pushing his man, pressing him up against the cage. Is he faking that, or is it? He looks as if he's about to collapse.
I think that's his real feeling. I think he just, there's a little bit of frustration there because, you know, the spinning back fist led to this position. He, you know, it's hard to be, you know, when you're that caught up in the moment to try stuff like that. A little bit of frustration for Muhammad Ayman to end up back down in the same position where he spent most of this fight.
And that'll be a big disappointment to him because the work he does when standing up can be quite electrifying at times. Showed that in his last fight, showed it in the early moments of this fight. But since then, it's been all about Kingad's strength and technique and control.
Yeah, I think the control is it, and the strength is giving him the ability to have this kind of control. He's just so dominant in all the positions. He's able to muscle his way when technique kind of fails him a bit. He's able to just outstrength his opponent. Outstrength, is that a word? I don't think it is. But he's just
out-muscle?
Out-muscle, that's a much better word, Steve. That's why you're the journalist. Look at this positioning. Like right now, he's got the left hand on the hip, right hand on the head. Muhammad Ayman can't go anywhere.
Less than 2.5 minutes in this third and final round. Proficient use of the elbows from both of these guys in this contest.
It's that improved Team Lakai wrestling. Their entire team has leveled up in that one area.
They have Man. Just really rocked it.
Oh, we got a triangle. We got a triangle by Muhammad Ayman. He's a bit more of a face crank. He's just kind of cranking on the arm bar now.
He could turn everything around here. He's got to push that neck back and pull the arm into him. He's
gotta,
not getting that kind of torque yet.
He's got to get a little bit tighter. Kingad's on his way out. He's a bit high, but he's close.
What an opportunity for Muhammad Ayman to turn this around, though. But the fans willing on the Filipino.
That's it. They're the elbows. That's going to do more damage.
That'll distract him.
Precisely. That's it. If he keeps dropping the elbows, maybe he can pull in and readjust this triangle. It's tight now. See, now he's starting to inch his way out. The head's a bit tight, so it's not quite the same pressure
still
in that arm.
Working on it.
See how his elbow's just a bit out of the leverage range? He can't quite create the hip motion to create that arm bar pressure.
Action!
Yuji Shimada calling for action.
This jam-packed crowd is on their feet, rooting their fighter, Danny Kingad, out of this horrible position that he's in right now.
No question, they're making a lot of noise here. Capacity crowd at the Mall of Asia Arena. 20,000 people all night long building up to our main event, the world title fight, but they are getting their money's worth in this fight alone.
I like how Muhammad Ahmad tried to grab under the leg of Danny Kingad, but this is Charlie. Kingad's on his way out. He's out.
Listen to the noise in this arena. That's what they wanted to see. 20 seconds left. And down come the hammer blows onto the face of Muhammad Ayman. You couldn't buy a ticket for this one. Sold out, and they are loving it.
Oh, he's pushing past, and this is where the fight has been contested, in this side control position.
It's
very impressive, Danny Kingad.
Listen to this crowd, and what a contest. And as we say so often, tremendous respect between these two fighters.
Look at this. This takedown was it. There's the face you were talking about from Muhammad Ayman. Just frustration because he knew he was going for a ride. Danny Kingad on top was unstoppable. The ground and pound came down like heavy torrential downpour here in Manila. And he was just, here's that triangle attempt. So close from Muhammad Ayman, but just not close enough. Let's go to the champ, Brandon Vera. Break that one down for him.
So what happened was Ayman was super aggressive on his feet, ended up keep on getting taken down. Kingad, once he was on top of him, controlled him the whole time on the ground. There was a close submission by Kingad at the very last round about the with the Bravo choke, and then there was a reversal. Muhammad Ayman knew he needed to win the fight. He threw in a triangle slash armbar with possible damage to the arm. I give the fight to Kingad.
Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of intense battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this fight in favor of your winner by way of unanimous decision from the red corner, Danny
arrived. How will Danny Kingad handle the pressure of being in a five-round world championship match? We know that Marias has been in there with some of the very best time and time again. He knows what it's like to defend the title, to lose the title, and to win the title.
Who will be the predator? Who will be the prey? I'm feeling our process at the moment. The opening 30 seconds, big outside thigh kick there from Danny Kingad.
Expect Marias to play the stand-up with him, to really start to see how Danny Kingad reacts in all these situations. Once he figures out the stand-up, look for Marias to get this match to the ground.
Kingad had an extensive 8-week camp. The champion, Marias, a 6-week camp at American Top Team. Marias said yesterday, I've got to be careful of the wushu style of Kingad. Kingad wants to stay in boxing range. unload the hands. He knows on the ground he's going to be careful because the skill set of Moraes is superb. Fakes the cross there. Does Danny Kingad. Moraes jabbing. Such a phenomenal all-around performance to capture the title against Akhmatov in Macau in August. And if Kingad wins tonight, this place will go into a frenzy that won't stop. Outside leg kick again there from Danny Kingad. Can you imagine if one championship has three Filipino world champions, Vera, Falayang, Kingad?
You see him just sort of figuring each other out right now. Lots of respect shown by both these martial artists. They're just kind of seeing how each other reacts. When I throw a leg kick, what do? When I throw the jab, how are you reacting to it?
Moraes almost catching that roundhouse kick from Kingad. Kingad's got to be careful. Don't leave the limbs hanging out there. Moraes will tie you up. He'll take you down. Then it becomes the Phenom's world.
But they're just naked leg kicks. There's nothing really setting them up. So he's not throwing any hands. He's not throwing anything after the leg kick. It's just one leg kick. So you can see Moraes start to look to catch that
half
kick.
Half time.
We said to Kingad yesterday, Danny, are you nervous? He said, yes, of course I'm nervous. But I'm also excited. First time King has ever been in a five-round contest. That said, he's not afraid to take Moraes to deep water. King out of his back now. Moraes wants to go to ground with him. And now this is where Adriana Moraes excels. What can the BJJ black belt do from here? So many options available. He goes to a very dominant side control position.
Did exactly what I was talking about. He caught the leg kick, brought the contest down to the ground. See how he's controlling that? He's kind of just setting that right leg in between the legs so he gets perfect control of the side control position here. Now he's got the head under the hand, the left hand under the arm. Good job by Kingad to get back into side control.
No tag back.
Half guard position for the champion.
Watch out.
Yeah, half guard.
No tag back. Touch here. Touch here.
Trying to keep him there. Will Moraes look to take that right leg out and pass to side control? 1 minute 20 remaining. First round. A lot of feeling out. A lot of dipping the toes in the proverbial water. But now we're on the ground. We're seeing more aggression from the champion.
This first exchange on the ground is going to tell us a lot. We're going to be able to see how Danny Kingad escapes from this bottom position, from a bad position. What do you mean? He's got 60 seconds to either survive or get back up to his feet.
Moraes now north-south position. Dangerous for Kingad. Scoots around. The Brazilian champion's going to take the back. Kingad goes turtle shell. Can Moraes get the hooks in? He's working for them. He's going to try and stretch him out. He's going to try and flatten him out. He's going to try and go for a rear naked choke.
He's got to defend the left arm. He's got to defend that left arm. He's got 30 seconds as long as he controls that left arm. Look, look at Moraes trying to sneak it under the chin.
Moraes closes the figure four around the body. That's going to affect the breathing. Here comes Moraes. Kingad in trouble. In trouble. In trouble. Adriana Moraes, absolutely impeccable. You've got to take your hat off to Danny Kingad.
Look at this. Immediately, the hand was under the neck. Once he, if he couldn't defend the left arm that was under the neck, the only thing that was saving him was Moraes had the right hand underneath the armpit of Danny Kingad. Once Kingad released the right arm, Moraes was able to go palm to palm and finish the choke.
Kingad trying to hold on, trying to survive. There are only seconds remaining. But that is a choke finish from one of the finest martial artists on the planet. He truly is a phenom. Adriana Moraes retains the strap.
To present the Predator Triton 700 gaming laptop prize for this match, we have the Ice Monsters of Predator Gaming. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 45 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke and still ONE Flyweight World Champion, Adriano Moraes!
Kitchik off the trouble. Kingad, an aggressive start and a takedown from the King.
Beautiful takedown from Kingad to end up in side control. This is where he loves to be.
Beautiful knee there from Kingad to the side of the head. Side control for the Filipino. House on fire early. Not how Satya Kitchikov wanted to start this contest, Mitch.
Yeah, not a good spot for him to be in against Kingad. Kingad loves the ground and pound. He unleashes heavy shots when he gets in the top position, especially in these dominant positions like side control here. Look at him trying to overland those knees, going up over the guard and dropping it straight down on Satya.
Satya Kitchikov, a four-stripe blue belt in BJJ under Gilberto Bottiglieri and Luis Finocchio. Can he use some of that BJJ now to get out of this predicament? Side control still for the King, Danny Kingad. Looking for firearm control. A very aggressive start from Kingad. Drills another knee. Where does Satya go from here, Mitch?
That's it. He's got an underhook on the right side. So now he can start to scoot his way onto his side. That's what he's doing. Now he's trying to reach for the leg to get back into half guard.
Popping right hand to the top of the head there from Kingad.
Strong Kingad is, has that whizzer on that right hand, just driving Sotir down. Now he's got the front headlock, look for more knees. He spins to the back.
Oh, have a look at this from the King! Explosive stuff from Danny Kingad.
Keeps going around. Sotir's got to move with him. He's got to scramble with him.
He wants the back, he wants the hooks, and he wants to choke out the Bulgarian. My word, what a start here. He's going to try and wrap the figure four around the body, trying to fit the breathing of Kitchikov.
Kitchikov peels the hand off of his neck, gets him out of danger from there. He's on the opposite side. Now he spins around. Oh, puts Kingad on the back now.
Right work there from Kitchikov. Now the Bulgarian has top position, got out of the attempted body triangle. Kitchikov, can he posture up here? Has some very powerful ground and pound. Predicted he'd try and TKO Kingad via the ground and pound.
Kingad's throwing the elbows to the bottom. He likes that. He's got a nice little short little arms where he's driving those elbows in. Now he's got the overhook on that one side. Let's see what Sotir can do. If he can try and posture up, drop a little bit of ground and pound on his own.
Kingad from the Igorot ethnicity, a group of mountain people known for their warrior spirit. Very evident so far here in the opening round. Kingad working off his back now. 1 foot on hips for the Filipino. Oh, sprightly done. Back to his foot.
Using that foot on the hip very well to push away, create a little space, get back up top.
Roundhouse kick there. But what's he getting?
Now he's going to start throwing those baseball bats of legs at Sotir.
6 centimeters shorter is Danny Kingad. Let's see if Kitchikov can get those long legs up.
See Kitchikov use that reach, use that jab a little bit.
Gotta watch that lead hook of Kingad. It's a ripper. It comes in quick and finds the target, then it gets out. Good sticky jab there from Kitchikov. Left hook from Kingad. Kitchikov just weaved under in time. High kick. Just whistles past the brow of Kitchikov. Beautiful threading jab. There's the use of the reach from Satya Kitchikov.
1 minute left in the first round.
Throws that distance, getting nice and tight. Nice little leg kick there, but he enters that punching range. Kingad.
Front kick off the back leg from Danny Kingad goes to the inside lead thigh. Kitchikov's going to start throwing a little more now. A little posturing and posing from the Bulgarian. Change levels, maybe drop a body shot off the right hand. It looks for a roundhouse kick. The support leg taken out from under Kitchikov. That was superb. big outside leg kick again. He stepped right through there. And the high kick, changing levels, Danny Kingad. More kick than a chorus line in the final seconds of this round.
He's really going after that lead leg of Sotir. Very effectively just digging in with those leg kicks.
End of the round, we go to the towers. It turned into a glorified kickboxing contest. And don't forget, April 20 in Manila, the launch of ONE Super Series. Smoke and Joe Nadawak versus the great, the legendary, Giorgio Petrosian. Also, Brad Riddell takes on Richard Ursel, Fabio Pinca versus Nong O, and a whole lot more. ONE Super Series, April 20 in Manila, is going to be insane. The greatest strikers in the world in ONE Super Series.
Michael, don't get ahead of yourself, though. We still got Iron Will coming up. We got March 24 in Bangkok coming up.
Bibiano Fernandez takes on Martin Nguyen. Nguyen looking to become a three, get it a three division champion. Are you serious? It's going to be nuts.
He wants all the belts.
Biggest year ever for ONE Championship, the largest martial arts organization in the world. And look at this crowd inside the magnificent Axiata Arena. And beautiful, stunning, I love.
Go!
Second round of three.
It seems so Kichikov can make some adjustments and slow down Danny Kingad. He's got to use that jab, circle. Don't stand there in front of him. Don't be a stationary target.
See if Kingad can bring in some of those side kicks, the wushu side kicks. Fake there from Kingad. Hunting down, growling on Satya Kichikov.
He does have chokes that he likes to go to.
Does the trouble have Kingad in trouble?
It's pretty tight right here, but look at the way Kingad's framing the shoulder off it, turns to the side a little bit, creates a little bit of space. It was impossible to finish right there. Now he looks good.
How much energy would that have drained from Kichikov?
It wasn't that much. He didn't really commit to the choke. Danny Kingad immediately started to turn his body to the right side and place that shoulder to create a little bit of space. So it frees up his neck. Kichikov realized it, let go of it, and it's not going to gas out his arms.
He's still holding the head. Here.
He's still holding the head. You can see he's still holding the head, keeping Danny Kingad away from posturing up and dropping the bombs.
Kichikov now back to his feet. Kingad picks him up! Boom! Shakalaka!
Opening, places the legs, and passes the guard, ends up in full side control, Michael.
Crowd love the big takedown from the King. Side control now cuts the hip in. Plenty of options from this position, Mitch, for the King.
Yeah, he's right now he's just choosing a knee. That's where he seems to like. He likes to get into side control and drop hammers on him. He's using the elbows, using the knees, very short range strikes, just softening up Kichikov. Kichikov's a tough veteran. He's not gonna go out like this. He's gonna start to create movement, but he's turning the wrong way. Still, he's turning into Kingad. He has to turn the other way.
F-10 in the corner of Sotir Kichikov is shouting instructions to the Bulgarian. Another knee from Kingad, keeping busy, working over Kichikov.
Good job by Kichikov to get back up to his feet. Threat that single leg, stood back up. Here come the knees.
Oh, the hard end! He went for the meet and greet. And now we're back to kickboxing range. A fake there from Kingad. Outside leg kick turns the knee of Kichikov. Those thunderous leg kicks to that common peroneal nerve. Body shots. Looking for the breadbasket. In goes upstairs. Just beating Kichikov to the kick and the punch at every level is Danny Kingad. And again, a right hook. This is Kingad firing on all cylinders. What a display from the youngster from the Philippines. Kichikov needs to find another game plan here. Needs to mix it up. What do you suggest the Bulgarian does, Dragon?
You can just see the way that Kitchikov's letting him pressure him back. See how he's starting to move forward now? I like that strategy. Start to put pressure on Kingad. Don't let Kingad get comfortable and start dropping these big shots. Look at that hook. There's so much intensity thrown with each one of his strikes. He's from Baguio. His conditioning is second to none up there training at altitude. Kingad could do this all night long.
And again, Danny Kingad more hooks than a Pirates convention. 1 minute remaining here in the second round. It's been a great round for the King.
We can see Kitchikov's always on his back foot. He's always backing up. I liked it when he was pushing forward. Put Kingad on his back foot, make him react to it. Kitchikov goes for the takedown, but a heavy sprawl by Kingad. Sacrifice there from Kingad. That doesn't work out well, so well.
Kitchikov, top position, half guard. Chance for him to do some damage. 30 seconds on the clock in the second round of three. Tries to drop the knee, tried to pin the arm. I feel there, Kingad. Kingad back to his feet. Kitchikov right on top of him, Mitch.
Now we're starting to see some aggressive Kitchikov. Maybe there's a little bit of urgency coming from Kitchikov's corner. He needs to start pushing it.
Hawking knees to the outside right thigh from Danny Kingad. Goes for wrist control. Kitchikov. Final seconds of this round. Jumps into guard! Tried for a final submission right before the bell.
A little bit of a flying triangle there. I like it. Look at that beautiful left counter hook from Kingad. Comes over with the right hand, slides under, weaves to one side, goes for the takedown, but got his head caught, and that's where Kitchikov caught him in the guillotine. But then Kingad picks him up, sends him for the ride. What'd you call that? Boom, shakalaka takedown right there. Beautifully done by Kingad. But Kingad is just easing his way and really just getting almost an insurmountable lead at this point. Do you think Kitchikov's got enough left in the tank to turn it up and get the win?
He's a wily veteran, Sotir Kitchikov. He's got many tricks up his sleeve and perhaps a couple that Kingad hasn't seen before. But can he close down the youth, the exuberance, the speed of Danny Kingad? Third and final round inside the beautiful Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It's ONE Championship Visions of Victory, wherever you're watching, in 136 countries. We hope you're enjoying the largest martial arts organization in the world. Right there from Kitchikov.
Kingad shook at his hands and almost took up a different little sort of wushu style stance there. Brings his hands back up to a more conventional boxing stance. Yeah. Good, I like how he attacks the legs, inside leg now. Was the outside leg, now he's going to the inside leg.
Kitchikov goes to the outside lead thigh, trying to attack those quadriceps. Beautiful sticking jab there from Kingad, then sprawls out. Nice takedown defense from the King. Up and over the shoulder almost there from Kitchikov.
See, Kitchikov didn't give up on it. He continually attacked, kept going for it, got the takedown. Now he's got Kingad on his backside.
Trying to find the choke here, Sotir Kitchikov. Kitchikov, he can never write him off. He won't fly the white flag. Always tricks up the Bulgarian sleeve.
And it's hard when Kingad is going for these takedowns. He keeps his head so high. Beautiful technique. Right into the armpit. Nice and high. Looking up. And that's how Sotir's able to try to get the leg, but he's not able to finish because Kingad's head is so high.
Nice head movement there from Danny Kingad to avoid the punches. Roundhouse kick to the midsection from the Filipino. Overhand right from Kingad. Right hand down the tube from Sotir Kitchikov. Kingad very vibrant, bouncing up and down on the balls of his feet. The more flat-footed here, Sotir Kitchikov. Good front kick from Kingad. They clinch up against the cage. Where does Kingad go from here?
Kingad's got a front headlock. Look for the knees now.
Let's go.
2 minutes 45 remaining in the third and final round. What has Sotia Kichkov got left in his bag of tricks? What's he got left in the gas tank?
He's kind of weaving his lunging in there with these shots. Now he's going for a takedown. Like how he did it up against the cage, though, Kingad's been able to stop a lot of his double legs by sprawling, and he's not able to sprawl when he's up against the cage. Sotir was able to interlock his legs and get him down.
Top position here for Sotir Kichkov. Fourth appearance for Kichkov in the championship. He's been a finisher for most of his career. 10 of his 13 wins, he stopped his opponent. Can he stop Kingad here with a rear naked choke back?
Got the back, but he's a little bit high. You can see he's got the arm trapped on Kingad's left side, but he's got to kind of shrug his way back down. It's going to be hard for him to finish, but he's starting to work his way down a little bit. Choke might be there. Oh, maybe she might have didn't like something there. I think somebody was holding on to a glove.
We mentioned earlier about this being the first time that Kingad has competed outside the Philippines. Doesn't look like it's fazed him at all, Mitch.
Not at all. He's a high-level martial artist with so much experience in his corner. Belagon, Panario, Foliang, just world champion after world champion. And giving him advice, grooming this young man to be the best martial artist he can be. And that's what we're seeing here tonight. But right now, he's in a bad spot. Sotir could finish. He's got some rear naked chokes on his resume.
The body triangle, the figure four, will make it hard for Danny Kingad to get a full run of air. It's a controlling position. You get a good look there at the body triangle of Sotir Kichkov. Under a minute remaining in the third and final round now. The Bulgarian in control. Rattling off the right hands and the elbows now. How does Kingad get out of this, Mitch?
He's got, Sotir's got the hand pinned on that one side, so he can't. All he can do is cover up and protect. But Sotir needs to go for a finish. He's doing the right thing by going to that side. See where the body triangle is? You need to go to the side. You need to put your pressure on the side where the foot is to alleviate a little bit of the squeeze from the body triangle. He was there. Now he's, I think he's going back to it. Now he's got his hips against that closed side, that entangled side of the body triangle. And so Tier needs to finish at this point. I don't think he's got enough in this area to do something because Kingad's striking back.
Kingad indeed trying to stay busy, even though he's got that boa constrictor of a body triangle wrapped around his midsection. Oh, hard from Danny Kingad. A great run home there for Sotir Kichkov. And we go down to the judges here in Kuala Lumpur.
Kichkov looking like he did enough. I think he did enough. Here's that big takedown that led to the guillotine attempt. Arms trapped, guillotine side. Almost impossible to finish from that angle, but very entertaining bout between two high-level martial artists.
Who will take the victory?
Thoughts, Michael? Who do you think?
You know, Mitch, this one here, very, very hard to call. I would actually tip it a little in the favor of Danny Kingad, but it could go either way. You're tipping a little in the favor of Kichkov. I'm a little in the favor of the King. That shows you just how close it is.
I don't know, man. We don't go round by round. It's a match on its whole. And at the end of that match, Kichkov was in a dominant position, going for the chokes, had Kingad in danger. It's tough. Let's figure it out.
Okay, Dominic Lau has the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of intense battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Danny Kingad.
Huge Filipino community in Macau, China, and they have turned out in their droves for Danny Kingad tonight, Mitch.
Hey, I don't know who got the bigger ovation, the Filipino or the Chinese athlete.
Southpaw stance, switching to orthodox, then back to southpaw, Mahalbin, jab through from Kingad. Mahalbin gets under it for a single leg. What aggression!
Rack and roundhouse kick. As the battle rages on, good takedown for Mahalbin to snatch on the back. So quick.
Halbin, hoping to get back into the winner's circle after losing his last contest. Before that, he was riding a magnificent seven-match streak. Ballinger back here, tries to put a hook in. There's Matt Halbin. What's Danny Kingad looking for here, Dragon?
Danny Kingad, he's trying to separate the hands. You can see that Ma Halbin has triangled that leg. He's trapped one leg. He's trying to get both hooks in. So now he's got both legs wrapped around Kingad's legs. You can see he's got a Kimura grip where he's got his own wrist and he's got the wrist of Ma Halbin. But he's trying to use that maybe to create a little bit of a scramble to change positions. Ma Halbin's a little bit low on the back of Kingad. Kingad's rolling, but as he's rolling, he's allowing Ma Halbin to get these hooks, to get his legs wrapped around Kingad's legs.
I think the chant going up sounds like it's for Ma Halbin here in Studio City. They are very loud. And still you see Kingad looking for submission on the left arm of the Southern Eagle.
You can't really submit him in that position. It would be almost impossible to throw on a Kimura from there, but he could use that to really separate the hands and maybe sweep or use it to change positions.
Rolled through again there from the King Danny Kingad. Ma Halbin refusing to give up on that arm of Kingad.
Ma Halbin's got a vice-like grip around the body of Kingad. Kingad can't separate the grip. Now he's gonna use it to roll. Now he's gonna, Kingad might end up on top if he can move that right arm over the head.
About that crowd roar for a prelim contest, Kingad and Ma Halbin, Studio City in Macau, China, going crazy for these two.
Nice reversal from Kingad. He's gonna end up in side mount here if Ma Halbin's not careful.
They were sold down a couple of days ago. Still the great crowd continues to file inside control now for Danny Kingad. Can he drop the elbows from here? Yes, he can. And the knees! Here comes the King! The big elbow! The aggression now from the King! Drills the knee to the side of the head!
A little top control from Kingad. The way that he's positioning and holding down the national wrestling champion, Ma Halbin, is very impressive. You know Team Lakai has put in some serious work in the grappling department. Look how he's isolated that right arm of Ma Halbin. He's laced underneath it, drops a little bit of ground and pound as Ma Halbin scrambles out.
The aggression from Ma Halbin. I should say from Danny Kingad, and then back to the feet behind him. Explode for Kingad! What a round for the King! Backs up Ma Halbin.
Halbin shaking out those arms. That was a lot of time he spent with those arms locked together.
Wild uppercut and a leaping right hook. A ferocious first round. Ma Halbin's gonna find a way to get Kingad on his back. Fakes there from the Chinese athlete. Step across inside thigh kick.
Halbin staying just out of Kingad's punching range, but he could attack the legs with some low kicks here.
Oh, the big overhand right, boom! Straight nice to the forehead there from Ma Halbin. And Kingad winds up a roundhouse kick to the waist. Goes a little higher up off the lead leg. What a round. Both men pulling out all the stops, turning back here. Trying to channel his inner Kevin Ballinger. And Ma Halbin returns the favor. End of the first round, we get to the towels. What a ripper! Minutes of utter martial arts action from these two athletes.
Man, that big roundhouse is what started off, and Ma Halbin slid under, but then you can see Kingad defending well, but this is that scramble. Ma Halbin does a beautiful toss, ends up on the back, and that's where they spent most of that round, but Kingad was able to reverse the position. Look at him get up, but Ma Halbin was able to get on top, landed a couple of shots on the exit.
All fights, all live, all free. Download the ONE Championship app right now at the App Store. Get it on Google Play. Watch every fight from every venue all around the world, live and free.
Seconds out, please.
And also broadcast in 138 countries, potentially over 1.7 billion viewers worldwide. Big hello to Philip Palomo, watching from Saudi Arabia, to R.A. Dekos, watching from Indonesia, to M.D. Ruffy, watching in Delhi, India. Inside leg there from Danny Kingad. The red trunks flying the Filipino flag. Another step across inside thigh kick. Overhand right counter from Mahal Bin.
Kingad seems to have found his kicking range. He's really able to put a lot of this just distance and separate the two. He's not landing a lot of punches. Mahal Bin's doing a good job of evading those, but his kicks are what's scoring for him to stand up.
Turning back in from Mahal Bin. What we heard from the crowd there, that was the chant for Kingad. It went up after another group of fans started the chant for Mahal Bin. There was a lone man shouting out Bin, and then a whole group of the crowd shouted out Mahal really loud. It was great. The atmosphere here, Mitch, for the prelims, are you serious? How nuts is this?
That's this card. That is the card ONE Championship has put together here in Macau.
Another sellout. Good front kick there from Mahal Bin. Oh, that was tricky. It looked like a front kick. Switched up to a reverse question mark kick from Danny Kingad. Outside leg kick. He's going to be careful, Kingad. Every time he's throwing that leg kick, Mahal Bin's trying to time the overhand right counter. That being the power side of the Southern Eagle. And there they're adjusting the chance again. And this time it's Danny Kingad's chant that wins out here. Match in the ring, and there's a shouting match in the crowd. I love it. Good outside crescent kick there from Danny Kingad.
Kingad has just found his range with the kicks, and he's doing a lot of scoring with these shots. Inside leg kick.
Recovery time here for Mahal Bin.
He's
allowed up to 5 minutes for recovery due to the illegal groin strike from Danny Kingad. Big hello to Ricardo Garcia, watching from Laguna in the Philippines. Big hello to Maxabed Malik, watching from Somalia. To Tigun Ismail, watching from Malaysia. And Mitch, talk us through this. There it is. Looked like a high inside thigh. He just clipped the bottom of the cup of Mahal Bin.
Yeah, I don't think I need to talk you through that, Michael. You did a pretty good job.
So recovery time here for the Southern Eagle. Danny Bernardo watching in Riyadh, and to Skinny Young watching from Madagascar. Truly fans from all over the world watching our prelims live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the ONE Championship app.
Good show of sportsmanship as Kingad apologizes. Goes right back to it though. Goes right back to this, says I'm sorry, and does it again. Completely accidental.
In all fairness to Kingad, he has been looking for that inside thigh kick, but you do run the risk when you throw that technique of going a little too high and clipping your opponent south of the border, as Kingad did there for the second time. A very pained Southern Eagle. This crowd inside Studio City in Macau, China, split right down the center for these two men. Now, Mahal Bin is allowed 5 minutes for medical examination and recovery. If he is unable to continue, an official decision will be given. Mitch, if we went to a decision right now, would you give the contest to Danny Kingad, or would you give it to Mahal Bin if we went there right now?
Right now, especially with the strikes that Kingad has been landing with these leg shots, you know, obviously the two low blows not in the picture, but
look, there's no doubt. You can see by the footwork there, the way he steps across, it was an inside leg kick, a step across inside leg kick. It's a Muay Thai technique, but it may have just been the outside of the foot just clipping the bottom of the protector that Mahal Bin is wearing. take a load of Macy Montana watching from Christchurch, New Zealand. I'm sure Macy's looking forward to seeing Ev Ting later on tonight against Koji Ando. We're live in 138 countries, including the Philippines, on ABS-CBN Sports in Action, in Japan on Abema TV, in Malaysia on Astro Super Sport 2, in Indonesia on SCTV. We also go to Hotstar in India. We go to Star Times in Africa, Stinet Sports 3 in Myanmar. And of course, all fights, all live, all free. Watch live and free on the ONE Super app. Simply go to your app store, type in ONE Championship, download it now. Wherever you are, around the world, on your tablet, on your phone, stream it onto your TV, through the app, and watch us live and free. On a big night here in Macau, China, two world title main events, including China's first ever world champion, Zhong Jinnan, defending for the first time. And Adriano Moraes taking on Shehei Eustaquio in a unification title bout. But Mitch, we're okay to go on here.
Here we go. At this point, you asked me the question, who would I give the match to? I gotta say maybe a slight advantage to Kingad, but there was that back control from Mahao Bin, but it is a razor close match at this point. Let's see if Kingad changes his tactics.
What about the inside?
He did it right there.
Goes the sidekick. It's a Team Lakai Wushu specialty, the sidekick. Left hook there from Mahao Bin. Kingad, jab two down the center corridor. Good right cross from Mahao Bin. Kingad goes for the breadbasket, missed the target. Nice footwork from the Southern Eagle. Inside leg. Finding range on it now is Danny Kingad. Outside leg kick, well timed. Gotta be careful again. As I said, Mahao Bin is trying to time the overhand right counter off the outside leg kick from Danny Kingad.
Yeah, but Kingad is beating up that lead leg of Mahao Bin, and that's gonna affect that move right there. His double leg isn't gonna be the same as Kingad starts to hammer on that lead leg. You know, Mahao Bin's gonna lose a little bit of that pop, lose a little bit of that explosion, but doesn't matter if you catch the leg. Let's see if he can suck it in. Yep. Oh, good reversal by Kingad.
This crowd going bananas again for Kingad and Mahao Bin. Bellinger back now from the Southern Eagle. Can he somehow find a way to get Kingad down, put Kingad on his back, and launch that ground and pound?
Let's just see how fast Mahao Bin can transition to the back. One minor mistake and Mahao Bin is all over it. Now he's jumped on the back. He's got one hook in. Oh, he might slide out the back though. Oh!
Oh, Danny Kingad tries to slip on a submission! But Mahao Bin out of trouble with the back to the feet!
1 minute left.
This crowd is electric here in Macau, China.
That leg's starting to buckle. Nice push kick from the rear side.
Outside leg kick from Kingad. Oh, there's the right hand, smack bang to the kisser from Mahao Bin.
That's his best weapon, that timing, clever hand right.
Two-punch combination, Kingad. There's the overhand right from Mahao Bin. Belly to back now from the Chinese martial artist. The aggression from these two young athletes, phenomenal.
Oh, big knees from Mahao Bin.
Knees to the hamstring, to that sciatic nerve. Mahao Bin bringing the round home strongly. Two down and one to go. A big hello to Ezenwa Chikawado from the Ivory Coast and Ricky Sabuya from the Philippines and Tolotot from Cambodia.
There's a little bit of the leg work from Kingad, but then again, that was that timed overhand right. Here's the scramble as Danny Kingad tries to lock in what looked like kind of a Darce choke, but he was missing the arm on that one, so he doesn't really have the same sort of positioning that he's got. The alternative grip guillotine. But good round for both these guys. Mahao Bin did a lot of damage there from the back, driving those knees into the thighs. But Kingad, again, he was working the leg. You know, didn't get a yellow card for the two low shots, so that's not going to affect scoring. But good
second
job
from
both these guys in a highly entertaining bout.
seconds out, please.
Third and final round of what has been an absolute cracker between these two amazing young athletes. Who will dig deep and bring it home strong for the final 5 minutes?
Final round! Go!
Inside leg kick from Kingad.
Look for Kingad to go back to those kicks, attack the leg. And look for Mahal Bin to throw that big right hand, transitioning into one of his takedowns as he tries to catch the leg.
Overhand right from Mahal Bin, it's a takedown. Can he put Kingad flat on his back here? This is where Mahal Bin wants to be. He works so well from this top position match.
Yeah, he does. Kingad's got to scramble, though. He's got one butterfly hook in. Now he's got to create, he's got the other foot on the hip, trying to create a little bit of space. Trying to attack the arm there on Mahal Bin's left side, but Mahal Bin's keeping it nice and tight, not allowing Kingad to sneak in.
Mahal Bin, top position, butterfly hooks here from Danny Kingad. Chance go up for Mahal Bin. And now for Kingad, listen to this.
Mahal Bin's got a heavy top game. He really excels here. Trying to step over the legs, but Kingad's doing a good job of maintaining the guard.
Chance once more for Mahal Bin. The field time may be ticking away from the Chinese athlete. The aggression shown by Danny Kingad in that second round particularly.
Second round was good for Kingad. The first round was very close, but you know, Mahal Bin's got to do something maybe a little bit extraordinary here, a little bit more damage, try to pass the guard of Kingad, end up in a dominant position. We got 3 minutes to go, and that's a lifetime in there.
Trying to line up the knee, blocked by the forearm of Kingad, who glances towards his corner, still half guard position for the Southern Eagle, now spins around. Kingad locking onto that right leg, grasps the hands.
Good job from Kingad to the reverse. Beautiful to end up in side control. Very minor mistake for Mahal Bin to not sprawl out heavy and give Kingad control of that leg. And Kingad was able to sweep him over and end up in top.
This version of Danny Kingad tonight is phenomenal. Drills in a couple of knees off the right leg. Side control for the King. And the elbow. And again, this crowd going absolutely bananas here in Studio City, Macau, China. Danny Kingad, if he gets a submission or gets a knockout, will bring the house down. Here come the knees from the Southern Eagle.
Again, Kingad gives up his back, allows Mahal Bin to secure the back, and look for him to drop those knees. Interesting choice to get restarted in the center of the cage as he tries to roll out. Now Mahal Bin's got one leg trapped. Kingad's trying to fight it off, going for a possible knee bar of his own.
Yes,
that's in. That's caught. He's a little bit too high. A little bit too high to finish.
It's deafening inside Studio City. Now the tide turns. It's Mahal Bin's chance.
Mahal Bin went for a guillotine, but Kingad swiveled around to the side to end up in side control. Now 1 minute to go, and it could be anybody's game at this point.
In the final round.
Just crazy scenes here inside of Studio City. Under 45 seconds remains in this contest. Wherever you're watching around the world, who do you have it for? The King, Danny Kingad, or Mahal Bin, the Southern Eagle?
Mahal Bin scrambles well. He moves very well from that bottom position to reverse. Kingad going for a guillotine. This is a very important pivotal 20 seconds. Let's see if Maho Bin can shift the judges' persuasion in his favor.
Maho Bin trying for something in the final seconds. They're all tied up like a ball of twine. They're gonna hear the bell any moment now. This has been something outstanding. This has been something phenomenal. This is ONE Championship. Great show of respect from both men. One of our VIP moments. Values, inspiration, passion here at ONE Championship.
Look at Kingad trying to roll for the knee bar. Maho Bin scrambles, scooting his way out. You can see he's just got to be a little bit further up on the thigh. Maho Bin pops out, and then the scramble commences. They traded submission attempts. A very interesting third and final round as they hug it out.
Wherever you're watching around the world on the ONE Championship Super Round on Twitter, on Facebook, how do you score it? Do you have it for Kingad? Do you have it for Maho Bin? Tremendous respect shown by both of these men. Let's go to Dominic Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the Blue Corner.
The boxing of Wakamatsu, the wushu of Kingad. Kingad in the red, Wakamatsu in the black. It's mixed martial arts global rule set, 3 5-minute rounds.
You can see Wakamatsu has got that right hand glued to his forehead because he knows Kingad loves those left high kicks.
Now it's a good kick there from Wakamatsu. Beautifully done, just buckled Kingad in the knees. Big hello to all of our fans in the Philippines watching on ABS Sports in Action. Also on Abima TV in Japan. Lots of interest in this one. Sellout crowd inside the Jakarta Convention Center for ONE Championship. Conquest of Heroes.
Kingad went a little bit high on that inside low kick. He just caught the cup in the groin of Wakamatsu. He gets 5 minutes of injury time, but I don't think from the way that he's looking, he's going to need very much of it.
Time. Ready?
Back underway here in the first round. Olivier Cost gets us underway. Wakamatsu bringing the power early on here with his striking. Goes to the outside lead thigh. Kingad edges forward. Wakamatsu. Nice whipping high left roundhouse kick from the Japanese athlete.
Kingad's gonna have to do something to earn the respect of Wakamatsu. Wakamatsu is coming in and out, landing whatever shots he pleases, and Kingad's just kind of a little tentative.
We've already seen some thunderous knockouts tonight. Could we see another contender for the Go Daddy knockout of the night?
Wakamatsu's very light on his feet, moving around very well.
Kingad needs to start checking those leg kicks. Well, the punishment will add up to that lead quadricep area.
Kingad's got a beautiful front push kick. I'd like to see him do it just to kind of disrupt the rhythm of Wakamatsu. Wakamatsu, Kingad's definitely got, he's awake now.
Danny Kingad's got a jaw on him. That was some solid shots. And the King hoping for a stomping sidekick to the top of the quadricep.
Kingad's got to start moving. He can't let Wakamatsu back him into the cage like this.
And again, the outside thigh kick. Dropping the tibial tuberosity on the head of the quadriceps muscle on the thigh of Danny Kingad. Outside leg kick from Kingad returns the favor. Probing jab here from Wakamatsu.
See the damage from that shot. He's kind of swelling up his mouth a little bit there. Wakamatsu's got some serious heat in that right hand.
Just for a takedown, there's Kingad getting at the Japanese action down. Picks him up. Puts him down. Wakamatsu back to his feet. Nicely done. Walking knee to the outside thigh. There's one to the hamstring from Danny Kingad. Where does Wakamatsu go from here, Mitch?
He's going to have to go chest to chest. He's going to have to take that left arm and swing it around the head of Danny Kingad. Danny Kingad now goes to the back. Good job of controlling the posture here of Wakamatsu as he's softening up the legs, which is a good idea because Wakamatsu is moving very, very well. Let's see if he can separate the hands. Wakamatsu looks like he's attempting to attack Kimura.
Watch out!
Kingad picks him up, puts him down. Wakamatsu's able to get away.
Let's see if Wakamatsu can improve his tracking in here. That's the hand. Kingad's got his own right hand cocked and ready. Inside leg kick from Kingad. 1:15 remains. First round. It's been all out action so far. Jab there from Wakamatsu. Goes to the liver. Then goes upstairs with a straight right hand. Beautiful boxing combination. Overhand right from Wakamatsu.
Nice boxing combinations. And the Japanese athlete Wakamatsu is moving very well, kind of controlling the center of the cage.
When he dips that left hand down, he's going to the liver shot. A liver about the size of a football, located on the right side of the body, a very good target to strike. And rolling through the door from Demetrious Johnson, hits the back of Wakamatsu.
Good job by Kingad. Now he's going after the neck. And what a finish this would be.
Opening stanza. It's been an absolute ripper.
Woo, what a first round from these two.
The handiwork almost putting the lights out on Danny Kingad early, and then the groundwork from the King.
Oh, look at that leg kick just attacking the thigh of Kingad. Oh, we got to see that punch again. We got to see the punch that did all the damage. I think this was the tail end of that combination. After Wakamatsu landed that big right hand, Kingad immediately shot in for the double leg. Wakamatsu was able to defend it quite well. Big round for both these guys, but wow, Wakamatsu landed a huge right hand.
Danny Kingad began in 2012 to turn his life around. He fell into a bad crowd as a teenager. He's on to become a 2015 regional wushu champion. 29-1 wushu record. And he saw some of the wushu styling in that opening round. Wakamatsu looking to make it 2-0 for Team Japan tonight. Moved from Kagoshima to Tokyo at age 18 to pursue his martial arts dreams. Became the star of Pancrase. The number one flyweight in Pancrase. And here we go, second round. Mixed martial arts, global rule set. Haimawashigiri there from Wakamatsu. Overhand right, looking for the headache maker.
Kingad answers back with a big left hand of his own, though. Like I said, Kingad not so reactive. Kingad's being completely reactive. He's not initiating any punches first. He's got to go first in these situations. He's letting Wakamatsu dictate the exchange.
Kingad controlling center cage. Wakamatsu on the outside. Comes forward now, the Japanese martial artist. Peppers with the left hand. Circles off counterclockwise. Drifting away from the power side of Kingad. Outside leg kick from Kingad. Looking for that common perennial nerve. Left hand just didn't turn the knuckles in enough there, the King.
You see a big difference between the leg kicks of these two. Wakamatsu is eating the leg kick, while Kingad's kind of letting the leg kick ride. So as he's taking the shot, he's lifting up the leg to kind of not take as much damage. There's a big stomping leg kick, though.
Trying to hit that common peroneal nerve, or the common fibular nerve, it's also known as. a branch of the sciatic nerve. It supplies the movement and sensation to the lower leg, the foot and the toes, and if you hit it over and over again,
beautiful spine, beautiful spinning sidekick there from Kingad as we just finished the anatomy lesson from the voice, breaking down for all you biology majors out there.
High right roundhouse kick there from Kingad, got out of the way of the left hand counter from Wakamatsu. There's a right hand lead, followed by a short left hook. Boxing combinations again. Wakamatsu, who began boxing as a teenager, was an angry, aggressive child, always getting into scraps. Boxing was his way of curbing that anger. Kingad tucking his chin a little now. Resets this Wakamatsu.
You know, might seem a bit
the
crazy.
Right hand there.
You know, it might seem a bit crazy, Michael, to, you know, put an aggressive child into a, you know, a combat sport, but it just helps you learn discipline. It helps you learn honor and integrity to compete and to train in the martial arts. And we're seeing that here tonight.
Both men very similar stories in that regard. Danny Kingad, as I said earlier, got into his own fair share of scraps when he was young, fell in with a bad crowd. It was Wushu, though, it pulled Danny out in 2012. Boxing that turned around the life of Wakamatsu. Danny Kingad, who became a dad in August. The birth of his child, Luordan Adrial. Says he loves being a daddy now, and he competes for a whole different purpose outside of himself.
And it changes your entire competitive strategy when you're competing for something greater than yourself. You're fighting for something bigger. It's an immense responsibility.
This is why you and Sarsi need to have a kid, and then you make a comeback. You see, that's a perfect plan, Mitch.
The return of the dragon. I love it.
Good left hand to a right combination there. The old 3-2. It's been a bread and butter combination for Yuya Wakamatsu tonight. Under these mixed martial arts global rule sets. 120 remaining, second round of three. Outside leg kick from Wakamatsu. Long reach on the jab.
Still stomping leg kick there from Kingad. He seems to be utilizing a lot of that. It's also slowing the movement of Wakamatsu. I like these leg kicks thrown by the King. You can see that. Oh, that one hurt.
The Wushu of Kingad, he holds a 29-1 Wushu record, won a regional title in 2015. Coming to the fore now for the Filipino.
Oh, Michael, that one made my hurt. My knee hurt. Oh, man.
Left hand to an overhand right from Wakamatsu. Hope you're enjoying it, folks, wherever you're watching live in 138 countries. And also on the ONE Super app. Big hello to Edward Falayang in the early hours in the USA. I know that Edward's watching this one live on the app. Watching his team, Lakai stablemates, Danny Kingad here, Joshua Pascio in the main event.
Man, look at the accuracy of these leg kicks. He keeps hitting that same spot. I know you're gonna break it down for just a minute, the exact physiological description of exactly where he's throwing it. Man, look at his knee, he can't even hold it up anymore.
Big outside leg kick again.
Colonial Nerve is taking a beating, Michael.
There it is, into the first round, we go to the town. So you want to hit the quadriceps there. That's where the muscle on the leg, the quadriceps, is at its thinnest. Incurs the most amount of pain, the most damage. What an awesome round of action. Jump turning back in from Danny Kingad.
Beautifully timed. Oh, but look at that, just stomping on the lead leg of Wakamatsu over and over again. Look at the King working his way back into this match by beating that leg into submission. Beautifully done. Now the movement of Wakamatsu is going to be limited. He's not going to be able to put as much pressure as he was in that first round. He's not going to be able to come forward with those monstrous right hands because that knee just might not have the stability to hold on to that power anymore, Michael.
It's not only the target where you place your leg kicks to that common perennial move.
All right, seconds up.
It's also with which part of your leg you drop the leg kick with. You want to connect with the top of the shin. It's known as the tibial tuberosity. That's where you'll derive the greatest strength on your leg kicks.
Back.
With the outside of the foot, not with the ankle, the instep, but right up high on the shin.
Top.
Here we go. This has been an absolute corker. Third and final round mixed martial arts contest global rule set. Wakamatsu of Japan, Kingad of the Philippines. Wakamatsu with the left hand. Kingad with that stomping side kick to the top of the knee.
He's going after that kick again. It's definitely slowed Wakamatsu down, but Wakamatsu's still in there. He's still pushing forward, throwing those hands. Big takedown attempt by the King.
Wakamatsu trying to get off the left hands, takes the back of Kingad. Wakamatsu a 90% finishing rate, 9 knockouts out of 10 wins. Kingad a 28% finishing rate, 1 knockout in 7 wins, 1 submission.
Wakamatsu's got the back now. Let's see Kingad fight those hands, break away a little bit. He's going to go 2-on-1, so he's taking 2 hands, and he's going to try to separate the grip of Wakamatsu. You can see him, his coach is calling for him to spin, go chest to chest with Wakamatsu. Kingad's trying to do it, he's trying to get under, and he does.
Roundhouse kick nicely done there in the breakup from Danny Kingad. Thought about a left hook. Wakamatsu doesn't want to give up center cage here. Comes forward the Japanese athlete. Wants to pick his shot. Get his timing right here. Cards in the hands with body kicks.
That was a beautiful combo. He threw the high kick, followed up with the left hand, goes right for the takedown, but good job by Wakamatsu to push him off.
They will be on the edge of their seats in Baguio City at the moment, cheering on the King, Danny Kingad. Now he controls center cage. Wakamatsu on the outside, trying to drift back to center cage himself. Fakes a right hand. Throws it on the second occasion. A little more flat-footed here, Wakamatsu, than we saw him earlier on. Outside leg kick from Wakamatsu. Under 3 minutes remaining. Good counter right hand off of Kingad's leg kick.
Yeah, Wakamatsu knows that leg kick is coming, so he's trying to time that right hand. If that leg is bothering him, he's hiding it very well. He's nice and light on his feet. I'd like to see him maybe change stances a little bit and come in with that right hook. So as Kingad is stomping at it, change the stance and come in with a big right hook.
Both men orthodox halfway through the third and final round of this mixed martial arts contest. Left hook to right hand there. Right hand didn't connect for Wakamatsu. Already a big win earlier on for Koyomi Matsushima, also on debut with ONE Championship tonight from Japan. Can Wakamatsu make it 2-0 for the land of the rising sun? 2 minutes remaining now. It has been mostly a striking contest. The wushu technique of Kingad, the boxing combinations and leg kicks of Wakamatsu.
Kingad has landed a few takedowns, but Wakamatsu's also controlled a few dominant positions as well. Both these guys are showing aggression. There's been some takedowns landed by Kingad, but some striking superiority shown clearly by Wakamatsu, but it's gone back and forth in so many different categories of ours.
Under 90 seconds remains now. Inside leg kick high up on that femoral profunda. There's the return shot from Danny Kingad. Gotta be careful circling into Kingad's power side as Wakamatsu tries to back him up with a straight right cross. Roundhouse kick, aimed for the liver there from Kingad. Takedown from Kingad, threw into the canvas like yesterday's garbage. Up gets Wakamatsu.
That was beautiful takedown defense and then a takedown of his own from Kingad. Now Kingad's got the back. That's ground control, that's a category, that's gonna score.
Danny Kingad, could he find a submission here on Yuya Wakamatsu with 40 seconds remaining? Only one submission and one knockout in Danny Kingad's 7-win career. Glances to his corner, those quirky moves to the outside bar, reaches into the canvas. Nice display of technique and strength there from the King. He's going to try and take the back and put the hooks in. See if he can choke out Wakamatsu in the dying stages. Got to suffer him up a little first. 15 seconds to go now.
Beautifully done. Was able to pin the right arm of Wakamatsu as he secured the hooks. Now he's trying to look for the choke, but he softened him up. I'd like to see him transition into mount. Oh, but Wakamatsu's able to get out of it. He gets on top and sets up the bomb.
What a way to finish this match.
A tremendous martial arts battle between two high-level martial artists. The boxing of Wakamatsu, the wushu of Kingad. And there's the true martial arts spirit, the Bushido spirit. Respect, honor, and integrity. That's what we're all about here at ONE Championship. Tremendously close contest, Mitch.
Back and forth in the third and final. Look at that leg kick again. But Wakamatsu landed a left hand of his own. He took the leg kick to give one of his own. Beautiful. Then Kingad went up high with that beautiful combination. High kick, right side, boom, left punch, takedown. Beautifully done from the king, Danny Kingad. But then the match was so back and forth. It was so close. I think we got to hear a razor close decision up to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Danny Kingad.
Big outside thigh kick early on from Florida. That was a beauty to open up the lead leg of Kingad. As always, Kingad and the team look high, red trucks. Look out for the cutting wushu side kicks on Kingad. Big outside looking again from Water. Throws the right hand down the tube. Looping punches there from Kingad. A little wild. Needs to settle here, Danny. Needs to check those low kicks too, Dragon.
He's got to be careful because those wild punches are going to give Tatsumitsu Wada that opportunity to duck under those punches and shoot in for that takedown. Right now, that lower leg's getting hammered. Kingad was the one that said he wanted to use the leg kicks, but it's Wada turning the tables and throwing those leg kicks at him.
Kingad must have heard you, Mitch. There's the first one to the outside lead prior to that common perennial move just above the knee from Kingad. Outside leg kick again from Wada. More kick than a chorus line in the opening round for the Japanese two-time world champion.
I never know what I'm going to get with you, Spello. Sometimes it's a martial arts lesson, sometimes it's an anatomy lesson.
A takedown there from Wada. Top position for Tatsumitsu Wada. Take the back here of Kingad. This would not be the start that Danny Kingad wants. Where does Kingad go from here, Dragon?
You can see Kingad's got the arm. He's trying to roll into it, but he actually gave up his back. He should have just stood up instead of doing that because Wada rolled with him, and now he's in the same position. But you can see he's trying to roll again. But look at Wada. Oh, look at Kingad ending up on top.
Slap it on.
If Wada makes one error with that hand in controlling the left arm of Kingad, Kingad could snap the arm up and get the choke. But now he's a bit high. Wada might turn into him.
And they're back to their feet. Kingad runs Wada down again. Tries to lift it.
Wow, the team Lakai is so great at scrambling. stuck in on one side, but he came over the top of the leg to secure a grip, and now he's got Wada in possibly a banana split. If he rolls onto his back, he can open up the legs and extend and basically separate the two legs like Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Takes the back of Wada again! And now he pulls out the top.
Ground. We were talking about how great Wada is on the ground, but Danny Kingad bringing those tricks into the game tonight.
Huge red belt on the outside leg thigh of Tatsumitsu Wada, courtesy of the leg kicks of Danny Kingad. Kingad oozing with confidence after a great spell on the ground. There's a leg kick. And that one went a little higher than expected. And they're hitting the cup.
Okay. Okay. Watch out.
Okay,
okay.
Ready? Here, though.
Ready?
The two-time deep flyweight world champion, Tatsumitsu Wada. The multiple Philippine national wushu champion, Danny Kingad. So many martial arts champions of all styles here at ONE Championship.
Kingad looks to be setting up a kick.
That's a kick.
Went high there. Stomping at the knee. Of Wada.
High kick there from Kingad.
You can see Kingad load his back leg. He kind of leans ever so slightly back and puts his weight into his back leg and then springs forward onto his left to throw that heavy kick. Let's take a look at the surprise of that round, and that was the ground game of Kingad. Here he goes, he eats the knee to the head, but in this transition, he rolls Wada over, traps the head there, elevates the leg, and ends up on top. And then he was able to get the back and do a lot of good work from that position. Here he is trying to go after the back again. Wada was able to turn around. Here's where Kingad was able to reach underneath and secure the leg. Now, it's important to mention that this match is a qualifier for the Flyweight World Grand Prix. So the winner of this match gets automatic entry into the Flyweight World Grand Prix, where they've got a shot at the best pound-for-pound athlete on the planet.
We are ready to rock and roll. Second round set for three in front of a sellout crowd inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, Philippines.
Back.
A two-time deep Ready? Flyweight world champion, Tatsumitsu Wada. One of more than 110 martial arts champions in ONE Championship. Fake there from Kingad. Nice cutting wushu sidekick from the wushu champion. Looping left hand from the king. Outside leg kick, that reddened thigh of Tatsumitsu Wada tells a story. Some shrieks from the audience for Danny Kingad, a favorite with the young ladies.
You can see how committed Danny Kingad is to each one of his hand strikes. When he throws a punch, he comes jumping in wide open for these big shots. Wada could shoot in if he telegraphs it right, if he can read him correctly, he can shoot in, slide into that nice double leg takedown he's got.
Front kick there, nice little skip up on it from Kingad. Wider stance now from the wushu champion. Sets a high left roundhouse kick. Hands may be ready to go. Yes, they are. Jab two down to the belly button. Jab there from Wada. Fake again from Kingad. Thrust out the lead.
Wada's got an interesting tell. He keeps kind of slapping his leg. And I think, I don't know if he's trying to, egg it on, whatever kind of, mind game he's trying to play. But Danny Kingad is going right after it, too.
That stomping side kick, the lead knee, the lead thigh of Wada. Silence in the crowd. And since they're on the edge of their seats, the sellout crowd just waiting for something big from the king, Danny Kingad, flying the Filipino flag.
Telegraph double leg takedown came from Danny Kingad. Wada seems content to sit there and exchange hands with him, which is kind of weird. We usually see, Wada trying to shoot him for takedowns, control on the top position, but he's actually choosing to play Kingad's game on the feet.
And now drifting towards his corner, Edward Falaya and Mark Sanjiao giving the instruction to the young king. Hook there from Kingad. Acrobatics didn't connect, however, but the crowd liked it. Wada's got to go first here, Dragon.
He's a bit hesitant. He's got him up against the cage, though. A nice uppercut from Kingad.
Oh, and Wada does a quick count of his teeth. He scrawls out now, closing knee to the top of the head.
He was underneath, cradles the leg. Now he's got his hands clasped together. It's a bad spot for Kingad. Well, I could throw some knees from here.
Knees again to the head, to the shoulders, to the collarbone of Danny Kingad. He's past the halfway point of this contest. Knees again from Warder.
You can't kick the head of a grounded opponent, but you can knee the head of a grounded opponent.
Where does the King go from here, Dragon?
The King, usually, I mean, what typically would happen is you try to fight the hands and stand back up. But typically with Akai, they scramble. They create some kind of movement. And that's what he's doing. You can see him trying to drop under there and go after the, look at that gable grip right there. He's gonna crank on the head, hammer lock. I'm gonna throw some more knees to the body here. Might go after the head with that left knee.
As he goes, drops the main side of the head of Danny Kingad. 1:45 remains, second round.
Look at that grip he's got, nice and tight to the head. It's almost like half Nelson.
Trying to open up a money box on top of the head of the King. Takes the back now of Kingad, gets a hook in. This could signal trouble for Danny Kingad, Dragon.
He's got both hooks in. He utilized those knees to soften Kingad up. And now he's got the back. Kingad's not in any danger of being choked right now.
Figure four around the body. Down like it higher for Kingad to fill up his stance. You see world champion Edward Flying just behind Kingad, giving him instructions of how to get out of this predicament.
The first thing he's got to do is he's got to shift his weight to the opposite side. See the triangle of the legs? He's got to put his weight onto that side so it takes pressure on the triangle. As long as he goes into the angled leg, it's going to put a lot of pressure on his body. So here he's got to shift his weight to attack the triangle side.
Kingad is glancing up at the big screens here inside the Mall of Asia Arena to gauge his position on Mambo strikes between the eyes of Ryder. Ryder didn't like it, so hides his face momentarily behind Kingad's head.
See, now he's on the left side of the triangle, so now the little bit of the pressure is going to be released, and now we can start to work to undo that triangle. But he's only got 30 seconds. Ryder just might choose to wide this out and throw a little bit of ground and pound to end the round dominantly.
Elbow there to the collarbone from Tatsumitsu Wada. Under 20 seconds to go, second round of three. The two-time deep flyweight world champion has the back of the Filipino Wushu champion. And still that figure two around the body. Now he opens it up, this Wada. And Danny King at top position.
And at least finish the round in a more neutral position. Here's Kingad throwing some shots, a little bit of body work right there. I like that uppercut. There's that three punch uppercut combination. Throw a little two hooks behind it. The second uppercut was the one that actually landed, but then it was Wada's turn to turn the tables, throwing knees to Danny Kingad, top of his dome, trying to open up that money box, as he so eloquently put.
Down, one remaining. In this tremendous contest brought to you by Global Citizen. Wherever you're watching, folks, in 138 countries. ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines. ABEMA TV in Japan. I hope you're enjoying just as much as we are. ONE Championship Heroes are sent live from Manila. The Wushu champion, Kingad, bounds out of his corner. So too, the two-time deep flyweight world champion, Tatsumitsu Wada.
All right, let's see. Right now, it's very close. You can see that in the first, maybe 8 minutes or so, 7 minutes, it was a lot of Kingad. Kingad was taken running away with this one. But then, in the last couple minutes of that second round, Wada was able to close that gap and show ground control, how he was able to get on the back. I don't know if it was enough to inch as far forward as Kingad is, but he definitely got himself back into contention. If he has a dominant round here, or can get into the dominant position, he may be able to sway the judges in his favor, because Wada is really good at winning judges' decisions.
Again, a silence falls over this capacity crowd. They are waiting for something spectacular from Danny Kingad. Inside leg kick there from the King, and then goes upstairs off the lead.
Shimizu Wada, 10 out of 20 victories by decision. 5 by sub, 5 by knockout. Danny Kingad, 1 knockout, 2 submissions, 8 decision wins. Body shot there from Kingad, belly button through the back. There's the left hand from Kingad. He wants to brawl now with Wada.
And you can see Kingad almost bury his chin into his chest and just start winging those shots.
In matches that go to decision, Danny Kingad has never lost. Shoots in for a double leg there, just Wada. To no avail though, good defense from Danny Kingad.
Good job by Danny Kingad. That's one area Team Lakai has definitely improved in, and that's their takedown defense. Look at it, turning the corner, getting Wada pressed up against the cage now. I'd like to see Danny Kingad end this with a little takedown, and he might get it.
Danny Kingad has Wada pressed against the cage. The elbow from Wada. Wada directed to the forehead of Danny Kingad.
Time.
Breaks them up here.
Time.
He was warning Wada about those elbows to the back of the head. You're not allowed to hit the back of the head. It's basically if you have a mohawk down the center of your head, you are not allowed to elbow or strike to that area.
Three times.
Here, Olivier Cost warned Wada multiple occasions to avoid shots to the back of the head. And Kingad took a couple in the back of the head. Olivier Cost stands him up, and it might be injured. He might throw a yellow card at him. Can't really see it from this angle, but Olivier Cost had the best angle in the entire arena, and if he says it was happening.
Owen Bennett, referee of the year 2018, Olivier Cost. Yellow card. 10% first deduction for Tatsumitsu Wada.
I want him to three times, and then he went again. We don't have points.
No. I'm here.
It does kind of sway the judges a little bit. If it's very close, which this match is, you know, it can edge the, you know, decision to an athlete.
Commence here in the third and final round.
Ready?
For a chance to compete. Grand Prix, Flyweight Grand Prix, will feature Demetrious Johnson. Wild looping body shot there from Kingad. Fake off the back leg from Wada. Kingad goes to the inside thigh, doubles up on it. Big uppercut went so high, I heard organs playing.
Wada's got about 2 minutes here to put in some work.
Inside leg again from Kingad. Two five remaining now. Body shot from Wada, left hook Kingad. Just tucks under the round kick in time. Wada forces Kingad back, looking for a takedown.
Oh, look at that, Danny Kingad just muscling Wada into the cage. But Wada continues to change. Good transition from the single to the double leg to change up his grip and put Danny Kingad into the turtle position.
That's the back of Danny Kingad. What can Tatsumitsu Wada, the two-time deep flyweight world champion, do from this position?
He's trying to take that right leg and slide it in front of the thigh of Danny Kingad to secure a hook. But here, Danny Kingad's doing a good job of keeping that knee nice and close to his body. He's doing that Lakai scramble that we see a lot of, trying to create opportunities in the movement. And he's doing a good job here. He's snatching the single, but he might give up his back in the process. And this is a bad spot. Look how his arm is trapped in between the leg and his body of Tatsumitsu Wada. Wada could flatten him out here, and he's got a minute to work in this position. See how the arm on the other side, the right side of Danny Kingad, is trapped in between the leg. He's not able to defend as well.
And he flattened Kingad out like a Filipino pancake. Kingad, posturing up, gets out of trouble, and he takes the back of Wada. How about this?
Good balance shown by Tatsumitsu Wada. As Kingad tries to shoot in heavy sprawl from Wada, this is that scrambling Danny Kingad does so well. They're always moving, they never stay in one position. You gotta work really hard just to hold Team Lakai
seconds remains of this contest. Knees to the head here from Tatsumitsu Wada. Top position, get top position. Elbow to the bread basket from the Filipino.
Just muscles his way out of that front headlock to put Tatsumitsu Wada up against the cage and to end the round on top. End the match. Very interesting round. It's going to go to the judges' scorecards, but we can see just the total aggression, the constant scrambling from both athletes. Very impressive display of takedown defense. You know, from, you know, Danny Kingad, he did a good job of stopping and keeping this match where he was strongest. Look at these wild punches from Danny Kingad. King was so much force, he almost fell over throwing the shot. There he is, exchanging again with a little bit of the uppercut hook combinations and a nice right hand that just barely missed on the left hook. Very entertaining match. Who's going to the Flyweight World Grand Prix, Michael Schiavello?
It's gonna be interesting to see how the judges call it. A great match brought to you by Global Citizen. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries, have it for Kingad, have it for Wada, have it for the Wushu champion, or the two-time deep flyweight world champion. Tom Lau is in the cage. Let's go to him now to find out our winner.
To present the medal for this match, we have Chief Commercial Officer of ONE Championship, Hari Vijayarajan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner.
Kato in the white, Kingad in the black. Japan versus the Philippines. Kingad from the fabled Team Lakai in Baguio City in the Philippines. Big hello to all of our Filipino viewers who will be watching tonight on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. Their man Edward Falayang in the main event later on against Shinya Aoki for the lightweight championship of the world.
You can see Kato's trying to keep that distance. He doesn't want to get too close to Kingad. He wants to keep that range, come in and out.
Kingad, the Filipino Wushu champion. Sento Ikeda, the Pancrase Flyweight World Champion. Shots go up. Inside the Rio Goku Goku Gigan for Sento Ikeda. Big right hand there from Ikeda on the left hook. Kato looks pumped. Look at him, smiling, nodding, calling Kingad forward, trying to bait the young king into a brawl. Kingad shakes out the arms. Just pull the tongue, be patient, choose your shots wisely. Don't overextend yourself. I know Ikeda is a crafty veteran. Big leg kick from the king and a jumping knee. And Ikeda calls him forward again. Crowd inside the Koku Gigan coming alive. An aggressive start from both these men. Kingad with a takedown dragon.
Good job by Kingad to wait for his opportunity to get that takedown, but Ikeda popped right back up.
Overhook on the arm there momentarily from Ikeda. Kingad has him on the ground now. What can the king do to keep him there? Takes the back of Ikeda.
Nice change of levels there by Kingad, transitioning, able to secure the back. He's got one hook in. He doesn't need the second one. He might transition into mount here.
Danny Kingad, dominant position over Sento Ikeda. 2 minutes 50 remaining, first of three. Can the king tap out Sento Ikeda?
Rear naked choke might be under the chin.
Screeches in the crowd from the Japanese fans who are worried about Sento Ikeda here.
Danny Kingad's going to try to get that second hook in. Good job by Ikeda to flatten his side. On his right side, he was able to press that into the mat and prevent Kingad from getting the other hook into the back position. Ikeda's now defending him with the arm. He scrambles, but Kingad is able to out-scramble him and looks like the choke might be there. The body triangle.
The figure four wrapped around the body of Sento Ikeda, and here comes some poundage from Danny Kingad.
who will go through to the semi-finals of the World Grand Prix Flyweight. Who will join Karen Akhmatov? He's already there. He beat Rhys McLaren just a few minutes ago. And Ikeda back inside the gap.
Good scramble from Ikeda to end up on top.
How about the loudness inside the Rio Goku Koku Kikan now? Ikeda. Replacement for Andrew Leone, and he is a man on a mission. He came out a ball of fire.
Can you hear back of that?
Looking for an opening here to work that right fist.
Kingad is just tenacious in this takedown, not giving Ikeda any space to get back up to his feet. Now he's transitioning to a single leg. Let's see if he can suck that leg, that left leg of Ikeda in. He chooses to abandon it, goes up to a body lock.
Kingad ends up in top position here. Side control for the King. The Filipino throws the knee. Cuts in the hips. What's the King looking to do from here, Mitch?
He's trying to control side control, step over the head, possibly looking for a Kimura, but Senzo Ikeda is not getting the opportunity. Continuously scrambling.
Crossing elbow, smashing elbow there from Ikeda. They duke it out, turn and turn, and the King catches it.
Down by Danny Kingad, now end up on top. He's got 30 seconds to work. Ikeda choose to create a little bit of space with a hip escape. Kingad goes to the front headlock, possibly. Looks like he's got the seatbelt, might transition to the back. Kingad, but Senzo Ikeda stands right back up.
High knee there from the King, outside leg. Ikeda backs him up with a right hand. Looping punches from the elder statesman here. Final seconds of what has been an absolute crackerjack opening round. Quarterfinal number two. We've got three of the four quarterfinals in the Flyweight World Grand Prix for you tonight here in Tokyo.
Man, it was all about the scrambles in that first round. Danny Kingad was trying to secure the back, but Senzo Ikeda kept moving. Danny Kingad was able to get the back, look for the choke, but Ikeda did a good job of scrambling out. Watch, Kingad tries to go for the body triangle. Ikeda's controlling that hand, is able to peel off the choke, and then he keeps going, doesn't give up, turns, ends up into the guard of Danny Kingad. Very interesting first round. You can just see how the magnitude of this event is propelling both these guys to some incredible performances. And you gotta be impressed with Senzo Ikeda because he was in some bad spots, but he was able to be spurred on by this jam-packed Japanese crowd.
Jam-packed indeed. We are now only 15 minutes away from our main show inside the Rio Goku Koku Gikan, sold out in Tokyo, Japan, for ONE Championship of the Era, the biggest card in history here tonight. Who will go through the semi-finals of the Flyweight World Grand Prix? Touch of gloves, inside fly kick from Kingad. He is looking sensational so far, the King. Turning back it. Team Mackay is renowned for, you'll see it later on, no doubt, from Kevin Bellingon when he takes on Bibiano Fernandez for the Bantamweight World title.
Senzo Ikeda's got to be very careful rushing in like that. That right hand of Danny Kingad is cocked and ready to go. You can see the flurry that Ikeda tries to do as he tries to rush forward and close the distance remarkably fast. And Kingad's trying to time it. He just barely missed with that left hook there.
Teammate J.H. Eustaquio, who once held the Flyweight World title. Our team Lagai would love that championship belt to go back to Baguio City in the Philippines. Three-punch combination, the uppercut missed in the air. Now what's over the right hand from Ikeda, straight through the guard. Kingad evades the lead hand. Looks for the ripping right on the inside. Ikeda backs him off. This is a tremendous contest, Mitch. I am loving every moment of this quarterfinal match.
Yeah, I like the leg kicks of Danny Kingad. He's trying to see him. He's trying to attack that lead leg of Senzo Ikeda because he's trying to slow down that blitz that Ikeda has. You can see Ikeda's just out of kicking range right now, so Danny Kingad can't quite reach him with the kicks. But as soon as he steps in to try to close that distance to flurry on Danny Kingad, that's when he's able to get those leg kicks off.
Big leg kick to it, certainly knee of Shinzo Ikeda. Wushu champion Danny Kingad, left of screen. Fresh world champion Shinzo Ikeda, right of screen. Misses with the inside leg kick there as the king. As Ikeda slowed a little here, man.
I think he's just a little bit more patient because he's taken some big shots from Kingad. And so he's being a little bit more patient in that blitz. He knows that, he can see that Danny Kingad is trying to time that blitz. He's trying to get that rush forward and counter with a shot.
A little bit of showboating, a little bit of evasion, and some attacks there from Ikeda. Kingad wound up by turning back and hoping to land the heel in the liver of the Japanese warrior.
Kingad's got to keep hammering on that lead leg of Ikeda.
One way to slow down the boxing of your opponents is to kick their legs. Ikeda smiling, that almost evil grin of his.
The burst of movement from both these guys are just, man, they're both itching for a knockout. It's like I'm holding my breath, waiting for it.
Kingad, double leg, take down. Ikeda seated position against the cage right in front of our commentary position.
Ikeda's very crafty. Look how he separates the legs. He's trying to walk up the side on that left leg to keep Kingad from sucking that leg in and securing the takedown.
Back to their feet, not for long.
Beautiful takedown and reversal back to Kingad.
It's an acrobatics there for both men.
Ikeda's walking up that wall like Spider-Man.
Punches underneath off the right hand from the king. The crowd rallies for Ikeda again into the Rio Goku Goku Gigan in Tokyo. Listen to the Japanese, they're chanting in Tokyo for Shinzo Ikeda.
Both these guys are putting on a show in Tokyo.
Sun leg kick from Ikeda, under a minute remaining, second of three. Flyweight quarterfinal number two in the World Grand Prix. Arad Akhmatov of Kazakhstan already through to semifinals.
Man, Shinzo Ikeda is tough, man. He's eating about double digits in leg kicks, and he still is unaffected, still blitzing forward. He's trying to scramble out of this. Good job by Kingad, keeping that body lock.
Pancrase world champion, back to his feet, not for long though, on his knees here. Kingad with the knees of his own. Referee Kim Ching on top of the action. Turns back into him, does Ikeda. Final seconds of the round, body shot there from the king. Ikeda pushes him off. Counter there from Ikeda, top of the head. Two down, one remaining.
Man, Michael Cervello, we're still in the prelims, man.
10 minutes away from our main show at ONE Championship, a new era. And what a card it's been so far. All these matches could be main event status anywhere around the world, but not tonight. Not on the biggest card in martial arts history, Mitch.
Look at that Uchimata. Right there, you can see Shinzo Ikeda trying to slide the leg in and throw Danny Kingad over his hip, but Danny Kingad was having none of it. Was able to stay nice and tight to Ikeda, scramble back up to the top position. This has got to be one of the most entertaining matchups of the night because both these guys are giving their heart and soul, putting everything on the line because they know what's in store. Now, I'd like to see Kingad keep hammering on that lead leg of Ikeda. Ikeda is doing brilliantly with those flurries, coming in, closing the distance remarkably fast. He's just got to get out a little bit sooner. Come in, land the shots, and then circle out to the either left or right.
Sold out inside the Rio Goku Goku Gigan in Tokyo, Japan for ONE Championship, a new era. Third and final round for a place in the semifinals of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. Three quarterfinals for you tonight. Already Karen Akhmatov through against Reese McLaren. This the second quarterfinal later tonight. Demetrious Johnson against Yuya Wakamatsu. King bouncing around the balls of his feet. Ikeda throws that nice little churning lead hook. There's an overhand right from the Japanese veteran, the Pancrase World Champion. Japanese fans tonight will be watching on Abima TV and TV Tokyo. Ignite of martial arts, actually the biggest. 140 countries around the world. Make sure you check the local TV guides. Who is going to put the foot down? Who's going to put the foot on the turbo in the third and final round?
Those leg kicks are working real well for Kingad. He's got to keep going back to him with those hands. It's the leg kicks of Kingad versus the hands of Ikeda. But then it's coming down to those scrambles. Those scrambles are so tight, but Kingad's ended up on top in a lot of those initial scrambles.
Slower start to the third round for both these men. Jab to Ikeda, upper gap from Kingad at the knee. Tries to pull the head down for the meet and greet. There's a left right by Kingad. Now the heavy artillery from the Filipino goes to the outside leg.
Kingad's doing a good job of moving his head out of the way. You can see the way that Ikeda's closing the distance incredibly fast. He throws those hands, and it's that head movement coming from Kingad.
Flipping left hook there from the King in the black and red. Sento Ikeda in the white and black. Chance for Ikeda again. You hear Japanese fans chanting, but that is what they are doing inside the Ryogoku Kokugika, and they're waving the glow sticks for Sento Ikeda. They're loving one championship, they're loving Sento, and here he goes.
Good job from Ikeda. Look, he was trying to slip that leg inside to control the back, trying to get a hook in. Good job by Kingad to keep his leg close to his body to prevent the hook from coming in. Oh, Sento goes over the top of the knee and still able to slide that hand. He's got 2 minutes and 20 seconds to work. Look how he's controlling the hips on the hooks. So he doesn't have the second hook in, but he's look how he's got those feet locked. Good job by Kingad to shake him off.
Aim from Kingad to the body, and Ikeda back to his feet. About 2 minutes remaining in this contest for a place in the semifinals. Gut puncher there from Danny Kingad. Left hook, Kingad, overhand right, left hook from Sento Ikeda.
Good head movement from Kingad. He's able to throw that punch and then start circling with his head to avoid a lot of the big shots coming back from Ikeda.
Oh, have a look at this position.
What's that? It looks like he's going for a Kimura trap here. Sento Ikeda might be able to, because of the position of his arm, he might be able to pull his arm out.
Danny Kingad. Anything with the arm of Ikeda, back to the feet now. 125 remains. This has been a tremendous back and forth battle. Look at the respect.
Ikeda can appreciate what's going on here, and the fans can definitely too.
Kingad kicked. Ikeda punched. A chance again for Ikeda. What an atmosphere inside the sold-out Ryogoku Kokugika. From Ikeda.
This crowd
is off and looks towards his corner. Coach Mark Sunjiao in the corner.
So, buddy, you've been here over 60 times in Japan. Have you ever heard a crowd like this?
Certainly, Mitch. This is a rarity. Outside low kick from Kingad.
Leg almost buckled from Ikeda.
30 seconds remaining now for Ikeda and Kingad to put their spot in the semi-finals of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. Ikeda comes forward. Both men throwing kicks into the ring. Oh, turning back fist there from Kingad. Hooks the leg, Ikeda. Finds the back, Ikeda. Like he's climbing Mount Fuji.
Kingad's preventing the arm from coming over to lock in the choke, but he's gonna get through in the last minute.
A little too late for Sento Ikeda, and we go down to the judges here in Tokyo. Wow. What a contest. Quarterfinal number two of the Flyweight Grand Prix. And look at the respect, the integrity, the honor, the martial arts values between Ikeda and Danny Kingad.
Wow, what a performance by both these two incredible athletes. Both these guys gave each other no space to work. Kingad was consistently pushing forward. Ikeda was blitzing in, throwing those big locks. Look at this. Going for a Kimura, another unorthodox Kimura lock coming from Team Lakai. Reminiscence of a sort of a backwards passion lock. There's Ikeda, has the back, was able to get a lock in. Look, watch the hand control. Steps one hook in, then pulls the hand out, frames out, has the hand control on the other side, is able to distract Kingad to get the other hook in. Now, he's going for the choke, another 10 seconds, and that could have been it. What an amazing matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Danny Kingad.
Is it going to be Kingad with his strikes? Will it be the BJJ ground game of Reese McLaren? This one brought to you by Red Horse. Look out for the wushu. The cutting side kicks, the turning back kicks, the spinning back fists. McLaren driving, double leg takedown, gets it early. Can he keep Kingad down? And he does. This is where McLaren wants to be. This is McLarenville.
That's what we wanted to see, that double leg takedown. He initially went for that knee tap after some heavy strikes were thrown by Kingad, and then he slid underneath and got that double leg. Now he's in a very good position right now as he's trying to frame off the head of Danny Kingad and work into a better position. Let's see what his ground control's like.
The winner of this one goes through to the final to take on the winner of Demetrious Johnson and Tatsumitsu Wada, which is up next.
Let's see what Kingad can do. He's trying to hook that foot. Right now he's looking at the half guard. Let's see if McLaren can step over this half guard. Nope, chooses to go face to face. Good driving takedown there from McLaren as Kingad tried to get up.
Full mount now for Reese McLaren. Kingad unable to return to his feet. The Australian taking his time, showing patience in the opening round here. This is exactly where McLaren wants to be. Nice stiff elbow under the chin there. And McLaren's eyebrow shot up as if to say, well, I didn't expect that.
Good job by Kingad to push that leg down to get back up to his feet as the crowd surging him on.
Loud crowd as always, sold out inside the Mall of Asia Arena. We had to turn them back at the door. It's the hottest ticket in town. One championship on a Friday night in Manila. Their man, Danny Kingad, working off his back at the moment. Reese McLaren, top position.
Kingad was doing a good job of preparing the pass. And a good job of getting back up and reversing the position.
Have a look at this. Kingad now, top position. McLaren holding on to that net. Now gives up on it. What can Kingad do from here? It goes to the arm. Up and down, armbar attempt from the King.
Kingad jumped in that armbar a little bit too soon. Risky move when they're dry like that, but I could see how he was going for it. You feel, because it's early in the round, they're not slippery, wouldn't be able to slip out, but submit Reese McLaren. Wow, what a shocker that would be, as McLaren's got the back now.
Breaking and crushing the face here of Kingad. Kingad breaks through. It's deafening inside the Mall of Asia Arena. At the outset of this Grand Prix tournament, McLaren predicted he would reach the final against Demetrious Johnson. He's got a second chance here tonight, a second bite of the cherry. Can he take full advantage of it? Can he capitalize? Has the back of Danny Kingad.
Kingad's doing a good job of defending his neck right now. You can see McLaren was right almost underneath that chin, and Kingad pushed that arm up a little bit. He's doing a good job of defending the hands right now, but he's giving McLaren those minute little opportunities just to adjust his position and keep threatening that choke. Danny Kingad has got to turn in, go body to body. Right now, it's gonna be hard for him to go to the left. He's gonna need to go to the right.
It started March 31st in Tokyo. It continued tonight in Manila. It finishes October 13 in Tokyo. The ONE Championship Flyweight World Grand Prix. This is semi-final number one.
It's McLaren owning the back of Danny Kingad right now, trying to sink the choke. That will tap out the King. That will send McLaren through to Tokyo.
This is his chance to spin right now. Danny Kingad's going to have a hard time, you know, utilizing proper technique because Rhys McLaren's so technically skilled. His opportunity is going to come from an explosion where he just violently turns into the body of Rhys McLaren.
It's all survival for Danny Kingad. 55 seconds remaining in this opening round, simple three. And the young King glances around. He's receiving instructions from that star-studded corner of his. 45 seconds on the clock now. McLaren's at his back for a long time.
Good job. That choke's a little bit high still. Still in that face cranker. It's extremely uncomfortable. But Danny Kingad's not going to give up that easy. You can see if McLaren can get under that chin with his right arm, that's when that choke is going to sink in. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's just a face crank. It's just like squeezing your face. And there's the turn. Good job by Danny Kingad to at least end that round on his feet to reverse the position, end up inside the guard of McLaren, and then getting up. This is where Danny Kingad, I think, made a mistake. He gives up a very dominant position here to go chasing after that armbar. And you can see he didn't quite have it. You can see him lock up the arm here, steps over the face. McLaren started to turn, but then McLaren gets that arm. He gets it up, his thumb is in the wrong position. He's able to slide the arm out. Risky move by Danny Kingad, but if you don't risk big, you can't win big, and that's what Kingad was doing. A submission over a BJJ black belt and a spot in the finals. How much better could his night get? But it's all for naught, and then Rhys McLaren was able to control about 2 minutes of the groundwork there in that first round. But now we're starting back up on the feet, and that's where the striker likes to live.
Second round set for three, semi-final number one for the right to compete in the final in Tokyo on October 13 and take on either the greatest, Demetrious Johnson or Tatsu Mitsuwada in the final. A sold-out crowd going absolutely off their rockers inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Big outside kick from the Wushu champion, Danny Kingad. And again, he sent a big tub thumper into the thigh of Rhys McLaren.
That's two low leg kicks there by Danny Kingad. You can see Rhys McLaren tries to ride the leg kick by lifting his leg up, and it throws him a little bit off balance. Kingad might be able to fire a right hand in there. Nice little trip. You can see Kingad tried to sweep out the leg with a low kick, and Rhys McLaren fell into the takedown there as he's now in side control.
Not where Kingad wanted to be. Rhys McLaren, top position on him this early in the round.
Rhys McLaren sliding that leg through there, easily passes. Now into side control. Goes north-south, and Kingad turtles over, trying to take a single leg there.
The King showing dominance in the stand-up. McLaren wants him on the ground. He gets him on the ground. The BJJ black belt now in top position.
Kingad was doing good work. That was a beautiful break in the action right there as McLaren slows down Kingad. Kingad was landing some heavy leg kicks, scoring with some big hooks. McLaren didn't like it. Now he's got the top position, and now he's slowly inching up in the full mount. But there's that explosion from Kingad to just get one butterfly hook in and to kind of secure a little bit of a half guard now. Now he's got to try to get McLaren onto the other side and start working back up to his feet.
Folks, make sure you follow ONE Championship on all your social media, on Instagram, Facebook, and on Twitter. Use the hashtag ONE Championship on Twitter. Let us know where you're watching from. to the back here. Does Reese McClellan, can he get those hooks in there? Kingad goes turtle shell, now spins onto his back. McClellan top position, 220 remaining, second round of three. Elbow there from McKean. This has been an absolute ripper. A thrilling contest, semi-final number one for the right to go through to the final of the Flyweight World Grand Prix October 13 in Tokyo, Japan, and face either the great Demetrious Johnson or Tatsumitsu Wada.
Danny Kingad right now, he's gone through five unanimous decision victories in his last five matches since that loss to Adriano Marias. He is a judge's favorite. Right now, he's gonna have to do something much more significant than getting put on his back like this. He's gotta keep this on the feet. He's gotta get back up to his feet and start doing more damage on the feet, especially with the uppercuts. Nice job by Danny Kingad to reverse the position. Now he's on top trying to pass the guard of Lightning.
Mitch, if Danny Kingad can stop Reese McClellan, I fear for our eardrums. They will explode with the noise this arena will make for the kick.
Can your ears get much worse than they already are, though?
No, no. Top position for the kick.
Oh, look at Reese. Transition into a leg lock. Looking for the heat, looking for the hooks. Can't quite get it. Gets a calf slicer, though. Look at the calf here. Look at the left leg of Danny Kingad. This is a bad look at McClellan using it as a sweep. Looking at that, using it as a sweep, but he ends up in kind of a darce choke from the bottom here. By
this is like a crazy game of Twister at the moment, all tied up in a knot, tangled knee to the side of the head there from Lightning Reese McClellan, the Australian.
Nothing.
30 seconds remain. Second round of three. Semi-final number one. Reese trying to hop under the back and ride the king again.
Beautiful balance by Reese McClellan as he's almost fallen through the ring ropes there. Danny Kingad's got to be very careful here. He's got to end up in a little bit more dominant position just to secure some points here. Reese McClellan's doing very well in his ground exchange as he takes the back. That's ground control right there, ladies and gentlemen.
Final seconds of this round. I see seesawing back and forth in Canada. Wherever you're watching around the world live in over 140 countries, hope you're enjoying all the action. Big hello to John, watching from the Bronx, New York in the USA.
Danny Kingad getting it ready for the third round. This has typically been his round where he does a lot of his best work. Reese McClellan is controlling a lot of the ground exchanges. His ground control, that's the thing. He's not just holding Danny Kingad down once he gets the pass, once he gets the takedown. He's moving and advancing his position. We're seeing side control, we're seeing mount, we're seeing a variety of positions, getting the back, trying the submission attempt. That is ground control, ladies and gentlemen, and he is showing it beautifully.
This semi-final surpassing all expectations. We are seeing a classic here in front of a sold-out crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. The ONE Championship Flyweight World Grand Prix, semi-final number one. The winner will go through to the final in Tokyo at the Ryogoku Kokuki Gun October 13th to take on either Demetrious Johnson or Tatsumitsu Wada. It is still anyone's for the taking. Wide southpaw stance on Reese McClellan, trying to get inside the mind of Danny Kingad. McClellan will do that. He'll play psychological games. He'll try and psych you out in the ring.
Danny Kingad's moment right here.
He went for the headache maker. And Reese pointing, saying that one flew out of the arena. Good snappy jab there from the Aussie.
Confidence is high on Reese McClellan right now. He's starting to let it all hang out. Then you guys see that character that we've known to grow and love in ONE Championship. This is Danny Kingad's moment as Danny Kingad goes in for the takedown.
Tried for a palm heel strike. McClellan double leg. Kenny sitting down. Kingad staying vertical. Now he
McLaren to clasp those hands underneath the hips, drive down to the takedown. It was smart. He could have picked him up and went for one of those exaggerated takedowns, so to speak, but he saved that energy. He conserved it, and he just gently put him down on his backside. Now he's in mount again, dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Beautiful groundwork by Reese McLaren.
3 minutes, 10 remaining. Will McLaren be the first one through the final in Tokyo? What a marvelous flyweight World Grand Prix it's been. And this has been one of the highlight matches. I'll tell you what, folks, this has been something spectacular.
See, McLaren's doing something with his takedowns. He's not just taking down and laying and praying. He's trying to advance the position. He's trying to finish. He's trying to go for submissions. Danny Kingad, oh, that's a very uncomfortable position there with that leg trapped like that. Now he's setting up that Dars. Look at that chokes. He's got a little bit of a choke there. Good job by Danny Kingad to kind of force his back to the ground to get Reese McLaren to let that go.
Kingad back to his feet. Danny Kingad, top position. McLaren goes, yep, I'm here. Let's see what you can do. 2 minutes, 15 remains. Third and final round. Posting up in that left arm, McLaren. Taking his time. Deep breath for the Australian. Kingad wants to keep him on the ground.
You can see Reese McLaren's trying to think about getting up. He's trying to use that post, work his way back up. It's a lot more difficult with the ring ropes. They don't have that circle wall to start working up on. So the ring ropes actually favor Kingad in this position right here. He can trap McLaren on the ground. See how he's trapped? He released that leg. Now he's going to try to scoop the hips away from the ring ropes.
Hands to the feet now. Can Kingad work the knees, work the elbows in close? It's the net to the outside five, McLaren, and another one. Trying to tenderize, trying to cork the quadriceps. Around the back of the hamstring, the sciatic nerve. Hooks the leg here, Kingad. And McLaren goes for the
run! And beautiful takedown there by Danny Kingad. I told you, his wrestling is a completely different level. He utilizes it very well. Look at him using it offensively against the BJJ black belt. And he's almost in mount. Let's see how Reese McLaren gets out of this.
Kingad looking to drop the anvils on the jaw of McLaren. Under a minute remaining. Same control, he cuts the hip in, drops the elbow, and there's another one. The ground and pound from the King. This place is erupting. Knees down to the body of McLaren, to the arm of McLaren. Elbows again to the orbital, go the fists. Side control, the shoulder thrust to the orbital now. Kingad staying busy, drops the hands on him again. There are the knees from the King, driving the patella into the ribcage of Reese McLaren.
He's trying to get back up, he's trying to get back up to his feet. Ladies and gentlemen, we do not judge round by round, we judge a match on its entirety. How is Kingad ending in this match right now?
The final salvos from Danny Kingad. And we are going down to the judges here in Manila for this one. It was epic. And look at the moment of respect. Two athletes who gave it their all. Who yes. will go through the final?
Hands on their knees, completely exhausted, left it all in the ring. Nothing to be ashamed of. They gave it everything they had. Beautiful performance by two incredible flyweight warriors. Look at Kingad. You can see Reese McLaren tries to get underneath with the butterfly hooks, and you can see Reese McLaren elevated him, but beautiful balance and control shown by Kingad as he was able to float over and sit on top there in side control. Did a lot of good work in that first round, or that third round, but was it enough to make up for the work and the ground control that Reese McLaren had in the first two rounds? And it comes down to the end. It's so tough to call. It's so tough. But let's go up to the judges and find out. Michael Spelli, your thoughts?
Sold out inside the Mall of Asia Arena. They will go absolutely off their nuts if Danny Kingad gets the nod here. A close one. Did McLaren do enough on the ground to edge it? The right to go through the final.
in Tokyo in October. Let's go to Tom Lau and find out who's through first.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two scores this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision and advancing to the ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix Final from the
storm early here from Kingad. Kingad in the red, Johnson in the black. The huge underdog, Danny Kingad. Johnson looks for a takedown early on. Short knee there from Kingad, looks for a takedown of his own. Johnson back to his feet. The balance on Demetrious Johnson, the base is extraordinary.
Yeah, Demetrious Johnson floats around this circle like an absolute butterfly. He's just, that's the problem with Kingad's gonna have to deal with, is this pressure from DJ. DJ never gives you a moment to breathe. He's just constantly on you. Chain wrestling, striking, takedowns, it's just constant with DJ. Kingad's gonna have to slow him down and utilize that beautiful Lakai style wushu striking.
Team Lakai out of Baguio City in the Philippines has produced so many world champions. They've been the dominant gym, the dominant nation, the Philippines. What a huge upset win it would be if Danny Kingad can take out the great Demetrious Johnson here. Short knees against the circle fence there from Danny Kingad.
Kingad says the answer to DJ's pressure is going to be his wushu style wrestling. That's what he calls it. He believes he can shut down all the exchanges of DJ and stop the takedowns and create that space so that he can utilize his push kicks and his strikes.
Danny Kingad, riding a six-match winning streak, began in March 2018 in Kuala Lumpur. Only the one loss of first-round rear naked choke against world champion Adriano Moraes back in 2017 in Manila. 11-1, one knockout, one submission for Kingad. The master of decision wins, Danny Kingad. 29-3, Demetrious Johnson, 12 subs, 5 knockouts, little cutting wushu sidekick to the lead knee there from Kingad. That was always going to be the big question mark. How did Johnson prepare for a style of striking he has not seen before? Wushu, and a wushu champion at that, Danny Kingad.
You know, Michael, I asked him about that. How is he going to defend against the spinning attacks of Danny Kingad? And Demetrious Johnson looks at me and goes, I have no idea. Nobody in my gym spins, so I have no idea how I'm going to react to it. We're just going to have to wait and see.
Shooting. Demetrious Johnson, Kingad on his back. Not where you want to be with DJ on top. 12 career submissions for Johnson. 3 rear naked chokes, 2 guillotines, 5 arm bars, 1 key lock. One Kimura. Last rear naked choke back in 2009. Last punch knockout for DJ back in 2013 in one round against Joseph Benavidez in Sacramento.
That was a beautiful, throws that nice little left hook, dugs under, dives into that takedown. That's vintage Demetrious Johnson. Now he's going to attack that far side arm, possibly looking for a Kimura. Good job by King and looks right back to his feet.
He loves the guillotine for Demetrious Johnson.
DJ said that's going to be the problem Kingad's going to have to deal with, these head snaps. It's going to be the basics of wrestling that he's going to constantly be looking for. Every time Kingad's in on one of these entries, DJ's going to be snapping his head down, creating this chaos. Beautiful knee right there on the clinch.
Muay Thai clinch here from Demetrious Johnson. Gets out of dodge, prevents the takedown. Now gets set down by DJ. 1 minute 30 remaining, first round of 3.
This is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about, that constant pressure. There was normally, in a normal exchange, you would give it take a second to breathe. DJ jumps all over him again, shooting him for another takedown to score a beautiful takedown to sit right now in side control.
Great look at side control there. Kingad trying to elbow the body of Demetrious Johnson. Far arm is the target here for DJ at the moment. Kingad could be in a whole lot of bother. 1 minute 5, still a long time remaining in this opening round. Knees to the head here from Demetrious Johnson.
Looking for a Kimura on the far side. Now he's been trying to step over that head. Kingad's got to be very careful right here. Look at that lock. Beautiful.
technique right there on the Kimura. Now he's going to try to take that arm. He's going to take his hand, try to touch it to the back of his head.
Danny Kingad in a whole little bother as the seconds tick down in this first round. Demetrious Johnson wants to take the arm home. He wants to take it back to the USA. But still, Kingad survives. 35 seconds on the clock now. And Demetrious has to reset, leaps into that position. Quick there from Mighty Mouse. Always speed, always agility, accuracy. From Mighty Mouse, Demetrious Johnson.
Beautiful job by Kingad to try to get back into full guard. DJ's gonna try to step over and pass that half guard now, slide his leg through. Kingad's doing a good job of just maintaining the position and not allowing DJ to get into more advanced positions.
Kingad survives the first round. They'll start in a standing position in the second round. That'll favor the wushu striking of Danny Kingad. And indeed, it looks like we're gonna go there.
Look at this, here's DJ getting that front headlock position, tries to soften Kingad up with a little bit of knees to the face. Beautiful snap down there as he floats around Kingad. Normally these spins and these transitions creating these scrambles work for Kingad, but DJ's just one step ahead in the scrambling exchanges and to maintain that position. Nice little clinch there from Kingad to land a little bit of shots, but DJ was able to shut that down, control the head, and score heavily inside that clinch position.
Nice and down the neck and the chest here of Demetrious Johnson. I'm looking at a man in control. You're looking at a man with the odds stacked against him there in Danny Kingad. What do they have up their sleeve, Team Lakai? How can they possibly defeat the great Demetrious Johnson? The circle door about to close. And we'll get into the second round of action.
All right, ready?
Ready? Round two kicks off. ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix Championship Final. Demetrious Johnson, the greatest of all time, a 12-time world champion. The overwhelming favorite, showing tremendous control and dominance in the opening round. Let's see if the Russian strikes the heavy hands and Kingad can get off here, but no. Immediately, Johnson has him on his back.
Nice little leg kick landed by Johnson. He stumbles a little bit as he steps backwards, but he was able to maintain his composure, get the double leg, and now he sits in a pretty dominant position here as he's trying to step over the half.
Mitch, if you're gonna try and pick the lock of Demetrious Johnson, what are you doing? How do you do it against DJ?
You gotta stop the onslaughts, the pressure. He's gotta create that space. Kingad's gotta stop these aggressive entries into the double leg. He's gotta time it. You can see DJ is gonna go up top with the left hook and then he's gonna dive in for a takedown. If he doesn't get the takedown and Kingad sprawls heavily, DJ is gonna continually chase the legs and possibly go up to a body lock. Kingad's gotta slow that down, create that distance with those push kicks.
We know that Danny can absorb enormous punishment, Mitch. Is this a personal boost for Danny that he's got it into the second round against Demetrious?
I think, yes, it's gonna do a little bit for his, you know, confidence to get into this second round. However, he is a wizard at coming up with scoring procedures and tactics to win unanimous decision victories and also split decisions. Team Lakai understands the scoring system of ONE Championship possibly better than any team in ONE Championship, and they know how to score points. But right now, DJ is the one scoring those points.
You are seeing a wushu champion in Danny Kingad on his back. You are seeing a 12-time world champion in Demetrious Johnson in top position. It's all part of ONE Century live from Tokyo, Japan. American fans live on TNT are enjoying watching Mighty Mouse Demetrious Johnson.
See, just a beautiful technique by Kingad to utilize that underhook from side control to pop his way back up to his knees and get back up to his feet.
Outside leg kick just to that common peroneal nerve above the lead knee there from Danny Kingad.
And also those leg kicks. Those leg kicks are going to pay dividends if we hit that third round. He's going to slow down the movement of DJ. He's got to start attacking those legs.
And a bit of pepper behind it too. One way to slow down the boxing is to kick up the legs of your opponent. Good punches start from the legs and the feet travel up the legs all the way through the body into the fist. So once you start banging up the legs, you naturally slow down the boxing.
DJ is so fast at that entry into that double leg. He throws the hands, gets you thinking something's coming up top, and just ducks under, slides in for that double leg. Now he's attacking the arms again. Oh, Kingad's moving for a possible armbar here.
You
looking for a belly down armbar perhaps here. Danny Kingad, 2 minutes remaining, second round of three. Flyweight World Grand Prix Championship final here. Kingad maybe sniffs a little bit. He's going to have to do something more extraordinary than that. He'll sub out Demetrious Johnson.
Beautiful control off DJ to prevent that armbar from getting deeper. Now he's got that cradle on that far side leg. Steps over, Kingad is able to retain half guard. See if DJ is able to pass.
Danny Kingad only has the one submission win and one knockout victory in 11 career victories.
Head and arm. See if he can pass the guard. Good job by Kingad to notice it, defend correctly.
1 minute 15 remains now. There is some swelling, a nice mouse under the eye of Demetrious Johnson, courtesy of the hands of Danny Kingad. I told you those hands are power laid, and they all are. All the guys from Baguio City, high up in the hills there.
Ahead.
And Team Lagai, all pack astounding power in
one
their
minute
hands.
Left. Yes.
Demetrious Johnson looks for another again. Kingad, four escapes, and Michael Schofield here good, in the second round.
Good defense from Kingad, but he's always on the defensive. He's not able to establish any offensive tactics. He's just constantly defending the attacks coming from DJ. He's got the underhook. Now we can see him pop back, way back up to his feet.
As you said before, Mitch, it's the relentless pressure that Demetrious Johnson puts on opponents. There's no room to breathe when you're in the circle against the great DJ.
It's organized chaos. It just constantly keeps coming over and over, the attacks. You have to be ready for that. You have to understand that once he puts the foot down on the gas, he is not going to let it up. So you have to control and you have to try to slow him down. That's why I like the leg kicks up top. Standing, because that's going to maybe slow down a little bit of the movement. Look at this, he's just constantly on him, delivering the ground and pound.
Big elbow to the orbital there from Demetrious Johnson. And looks like we're going to go to the third round, a place where a lot of people thought Danny Kingad would not get into.
Look at DJ, touching him up on the feet, but a beautiful left hook landed by Kingad. Stumbles DJ, but DJ, being the veteran that he is, ties up the legs, puts Kingad back down. Just constantly putting that pressure on Kingad, never giving him a moment to reset and to establish his striking rhythm. It just constantly keeps coming with him. But I would expect DJ to do exactly the same thing that he did in the first and the second round. He's gonna show the hands, get Kingad thinking up top, and then he's gonna start ducking underneath to slide in for that double leg. Kingad's got to have an answer to that double leg takedown and stop DJ from shooting in.
Great crowd inside the Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo, witnessing an epic Flyweight World Grand Prix Championship final between Danny Kingad and Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson. Third and final round. Oliver Costa got us underway. Where are you watching, folks, in over 140 countries? How do you see it at the moment? What does Danny Kingad need to do to cause what would be the upset of all upsets? He's got to sling those hands. He's got to pull the trigger, throw the heavy artillery now. But DJ is so slick. DJ is so elusive, so hard to catch. Constantly on the balls of his feet, constantly cutting angles.
See, even when Kingad does start to go for the legs, DJ rides it, switches stances, and then immediately fires his hands.
Tempting. Trying to play mind games with young Danny Kingad.
Like that though, Kingad saw it, wasn't fazed by it, goes after the head kick. And beautiful entry, double leg, ties up the legs, puts Kingad on his back.
Once again, Danny Kingad finds himself in Johnson land. He finds himself in Demetriousville. This is not where you want to be against a 12-time world champion. Demetrious Johnson inside the half guard. So many options here for Mighty Mouse.
It just goes to show you just how good Johnson was, because even high-level wrestlers like Reese McLaren were not able to do this to Danny Kingad. Danny Kingad was able to utilize those explosions that Team Lakai is known for and to create those scrambles. That's what DJ said he was a little bit worried about, how he would handle it, but he's able to out-scramble even the best scramblers.
Danny Kingad now knows that time is against him.
beautiful faked one time, popped the hips up. As soon as Kingad put his feet on the canvas, Demetrious floated over past guard. Now he's gonna start attacking that far arm, the right arm of Kingad, possibly looking for another Kimura.
12 pro outings for Danny Kingad, 32 for Demetrious Johnson. The experience shining through here on the 12th time world champion. Some peppering fists off his back here from Danny Kingad, but not enough to disturb Johnson at all.
So he slides his hip in, how he controls the left leg of Kingad. He gets his knee nice and tight underneath the hip there, so that prevents a lot of the movement coming from Kingad.
Who will be crowned the Flyweight World Grand Prix champion here in Tokyo, Japan, inside the Ryogoku Kokukikan at 1 century? At the moment, it's definitely looking like Demetrious Johnson. Can Kingad find a way to get back to his feet, to deliver that wushu striking arsenal of hits? He's got half a round to do so, Dragon.
Did a good job of getting back into half guard. He's even got the underhook on the right arm. You can see it right there. That's how he's utilized the underhook to get back up to his feet. But Demetrious just one step ahead of him, playing that physical chess game to maintain his positions.
Crowd here in Tokyo, absolutely spellbound. They have received Demetrious Johnson like no other. They respect this man's talents. As he tries to lock on a choke here of Danny Kingad. And Kingad with top position momentarily. What can Danny Kingad do from here now?
Kingad with the body lock takedown, spins DJ around, puts him up against the circle wall.
Watch out.
First elbows here from Johnson, 1:45 on the clock now. Good look at that hematoma under the right eye of Demetrious that made its appearance, said hello to the world in the opening round.
DJ's doing a good job working his way back into an active guard position. Let's see if Kingad can step over and pass in a half. Good job of controlling the legs, elevating the left leg there of DJ, right leg, sorry.
You just wonder what he could do in a desperation moment. Should this one get back to its feet for Danny the King Kingad?
But even when it does get to the feet, DJ's got some excellent kickboxing. AMC, so you can expect DJ to have any answers for him on feet.
We are there now. Danny Kingad gets back to his feet against Demetrious Johnson. Now's the chance for Kingad. Now's where Kingad needs to dig deep into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude. But again, he goes down. He's on his back, and DJ's on top of him. He had a moment. There was a sniff there, an opening for Kingad.
Kingad went for that Uchimata again, had the underhook, but DJ actually chose to cartwheel over with him and then land in the side control position. Beautiful technical defense from DJ.
Side control for Demetrious Johnson. 30 seconds to go. Is Johnson about to become the Flyweight World Grand Prix champion here in Tokyo?
Nice little burst there from Kingad, working his way back up to his knees, but DJ might be able to take the back here.
He's done so many things so well. Another highly intelligent performance from Demetrious Johnson. Tried to sink a hook in, gets one hook in now. We're going to go down to the judges here in Tokyo. Demetrious Johnson, superb. DJ pumps his fist in the air. What a performance, Dragon.
Man, it was just some epic scrambles. This was beautiful. You can see DJ going for the armbar there. Kingad has done his research on the greatest of all time, knew exactly what was coming, able to keep his arms nice and tight to the body. Look at Kingad taking DJ for the ride, putting DJ on his backside. Was able to scramble out, but DJ just kept moving. The gas tank, the man that's lived and breathed in those championship rounds. You knew 3 rounds was not gonna be a problem for DJ. But I gotta tell you, Michael Schiavello, I am extremely impressed with the grappling ability of the King.
Danny Kingad can hold his chin high, take a hat off if you're wearing one for Danny Kingad. To come in as such an underdog, go the distance against the greatest Demetrious Johnson. Put that mouse under Johnson's eye and give him a true test. Amazing performance from Danny Kingad. Chatri Sichitong to present the belt. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix Champion from the red corner, Demetrious Johnson!
But Yuya says he will do it tonight.
The only person to ever finish Danny Kingad, Adriano Moraes, flyweight king. Yuya just cracked Danny Kingad with that right hand.
Jab there from Kingad. Yuya will look for an aggressive start. Kingad scores outside fly kick.
Took the legs out from Yuya with that leg kick.
Danny Kingad renowned for his explosivity. Says he wants to roll that kick to Demetrious Johnson. The chants go up inside the sold-out Ball of Asia arena for the King, Danny Kingad. Outside leg kick from Kingad. Out who defeated Ikeda and Rich McLaren to reach the final of the Flyweight World Grand Prix before losing by decision to Demetrious Johnson in Tokyo. Knee there from Yuya.
Yuya's got that front headlock position. Let's see if he chooses to go for some knees. Kingad might be able to suck in a leg. That right leg is a little bit too close to Kingad. Kingad might be able to take that, those arms, wrap up that single leg and pull him in.
Yuya keep the streak alive and make it six in a row. Kingad looking for a way back to his feet. What's up for a single? Picks him up and shakalaka!
Nice takedown by Danny Kingad. Got that takedown, sucked in that leg, picked him up, sent him for a ride. Now we get to see what Yuya is like off his ground, off the ground game. Haven't seen him here in this kind of position in a while. He's usually just blitzing on people with the hands. Now he's gonna have to work to get back up.
Half-guard position, Danny Kingad, 3 minutes, 5 remaining, first round of 3. Big takedown from the King moments ago, set the crowd on fire here in Manila. What does Yuya do from his back here, Craig?
First thing Yuya's got to do is take that left arm and start digging for underhooks. Right now he's got an overhook, but he does a good job of getting back into full guard. Now he's got that butterfly guard. Look for him to try to elevate Danny Kingad's hips and create a little bit of a scramble so he can get moving.
Keeping the Chinese athlete on his back, now inside control the kick.
Good job using that wizard to control the position of Yuya. Now he's in a worse position inside control. This is where Danny Kingad likes to be. He likes to smother his opponents, out-wrestle them, out-scramble them. Now he's going knee on belly, might choose to go into mount here. I know Danny Kingad wants a finish. He's been kind of known as the decision guy lately. He wants to wrap this up and get a win.
Hasn't had a finish since 2016, an armbar submission over Eugene Takeira. All the wins since then have been by decision for Danny the King Kingad. Back to the feet now. Front kick there from Yuya. Kingad looking in great condition, as always. Big outside leg kick. Yuya looking through his brow, gloves up high. Kingad banks off the right, spins the legs again, hits that common perennial move.
You also see the leg kicks are kind of targeting that lower part of the leg, right near that knee and that calf. What's that going to do if you guys have watched Xiaowei's matches in the past? He likes to explode forward with punches. He's not going to be able to do that if Danny Kingad keeps beating on that leg like that.
Danny Kingad from the famed Team Lagai in Baguio City. The team that back in 2018 owned 4 of a possible 8 world titles in the men's divisions at ONE Championship. They have one sole world champion remaining. We'll see him in our main event tonight, Joshua Pascio against Alex Silva for the strawweight strap.
You can see Kingad's choosing to stomp on that leg. He's either choosing to go inside or he's going to that stomp onto that leg, that oblique kick. He's trying to hyperextend that lead leg. And there he is, just keeps kicking that leg. Those are scoring points, but it's going to pay dividends later in the matchup, especially if Yuya tries to get up off that stool in the second and that leg starts to build up that small tightness. He's landed again.
Getting in the leg. just above the lead knee of Sherwang. 20 seconds to go. First round of three. Nice left hook there from Kingad. Outside leg kick again. Here's Tinker rising. That lead fly, top of the knee area. Goes up to the ribs. Nine front kick. Gets out of the way of the counter right hand from Sherwang. And the first big out of the towel. Folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms at ONE Championship on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram.
There he is attempting a body kick, but a beautiful little punch is off the catch there. Here he is picking him up, has that leg tracked, sends him for the ride. Beautiful takedown by Danny Kingad, but then it all came down to those kicks. Just Danny Kingad just letting go with those leg kicks over and over, beating on the legs of Siewe.
And there they are, that glorious Arnis team that got 14 gold medals at the 30th Southeast Asian Games. Filipino national martial art, Arnis, represented here tonight. And they are all cheering for Danny Kingad.
See those new ONE shirts with the Philippines on it, with the Philippine flag? Picked up three of them earlier. Excited about those new shirts.
They are on sale tonight, and also go to the ONE shop on the ONE Championship website. Here we go, second round of three. They touch gloves. Great leg kicks in the opening 5 minutes from the King Danny Kingad, and a skip up roundhouse to start the second stanza.
Expect Danny Kingad to keep going back to that leg, just stomping on it and beating up the outside. That's going to pay just a lot of good work as he starts to slow down the movement of Xiewe.
Danny trying to careen into that lead leg again.
Xiewe's got to start checking some of these kicks, either checking them or coming forward and throwing a right hand, hoping to catch Danny Kingad off balance, because right now, Kingad's chewing up that leg.
Kingad is a decorated wushu stylist, but those leg kicks are more Muay Thai style than wushu, but are coming from Danny Kingad tonight. Looking very confident and built as Danny Kingad. Xiewei needs to find some way to change it up here. Jab two, Kingad gets out of dodge.
You got to keep in mind that Xiewei did train at the Shaolin Temple, so I can imagine all the body toughening exercises that he was doing, like iron rods against the Shimi.
Shaolin, you know what I mean?
They're tough, dude. They're all sorts of crazy stuff coming out of Shaolin Temple, but I like what Danny Kingad's got to do. He's got to get out of this pressure position right now. He's got to try to swim the arms in, get those underhooks, and then redirect.
Right now, from both men, Xiewei going to the thigh, Danny Kingad going up to the body. Xiewei comes in tonight on a magnificent five-win streak, three wins in the very first round. Won't make it four first-round finishes tonight, but can he keep the streak alive? A little shoulder thrust there from Xiewei. Kingad receiving instructions from his corner, that decorated corner. Team Lagai out in force tonight. Honorio Benario's here. Jay, how you stuck, Leo? Both former world champions. He's there from Kingad. Glances up at the big screen in the arena here to see how much time is left. Takedown from Xiewei. Kingad back to his feet.
See, when he has those double underhooks, see how he has both arms underneath the arms of Danny Kingad? That's going to enable him to kind of control and have a little bit better position inside this clinch. And that's where he was able to try to get that takedown a little bit earlier. But with the takedown, you have to take them down and control their hips. It's not counted as a takedown unless you get control of those hips.
Sure way. Foot stop there. Knee looking for the midsection, but Danny's defending with that left hand on top of the thigh of Xiewei.
I guess break.
And referee Olivier Goss wants to see more action. He breaks it. The crowd appreciates it. I'm sure that Danny Kingad did too.
Good break. Xiewei needs to do a little bit more with that.
Jab from Kingad immediately gets out of range for the counter strike. Big overhand right. Xiewei loaded up on that one. Kingad outside thigh kick, jab two, retaliatory there from Xiewei. Overhand right from Kingad. 1:35 on the clock, second round of three. Turning back kick, hoping for the liver section. We will see some of those, I'm sure, from Edward Folayang. He's up next against the very tough Peter Bouts from the Netherlands. Jab, overhand right from Kingad. Chiu-Wei, jab right cross down the center corridor. Looks for the outside leg, there's the counter, hits the sciatic nerve. Is that one that's Kingad?
Chiu-Wei's got good reaction time when it comes to the punches coming from Kingad. You can see where his skill set kind of lies in the boxing. But when it comes to the leg kicks, all he's doing is taking the leg kick over and over again. And that's what Danny Kingad needs to go back to. He needs to keep kicking that leg.
Adding side kick to the lead 5-8 from Kingad is dangerous. But there's the outside leg kick, the roundhouse from Kingad.
There's not a lot of damage shown on the leg of Chiu-Wei. He seems to be okay. Good sprawl there by Chiu-Wei as he's able to stop that takedown.
I don't know, Mitch. I think if you pull up the hem of the shorts of Chiu-Wei, you are going to see a kaleidoscope of colors. Knees now from the King. The King without a crown, who says he wants a rematch with Demetrious Johnson. Final 10 seconds of another very good round from Danny Kingad. The trio from Team Lakai. Kingad, Folayang, Pacio, all in action tonight as Kingad finishes the second with a spinning back elbow.
Yeah, Michael, you are right. Those leg kicks are starting to add up. You can start to see just the purpling and blue colors that's developing on that lower leg of Chiu-Wei. Nice little shoulder bumps there. That's something that's been added into mixed martial arts as of late. Chiu-Wei trying to bump his way into scoring a little bit of damage on Danny Kingad. But Chiu-Wei needs to change things up right now. He needs to go back to what brought him to the show and let those hands go.
He tried to spit that. Shoulder bumps in mixed martial arts have been around for a long, long, long time.
But now they're here. Now they're in the limelight. Now they're showcased on a different level. And they just threw them out there. So it's good to see.
It is great to see it. Third round, final round. Danny Kingad in control. The leg kicks to the lead thigh, just above the lead knee of Chiu-Wei have done damage. Chiu-Wei's got to find a way to turn around here. Needs to be inventive. Needs to up the aggression. Needs to start landing and doing some damage on Kingad. Comes forward with a jab over the Chinese athlete. Good roundhouse kick. Misses with the lead hook. Downward elbow counter. That was very brash from Chiu-Wei. He is in danger of having that streak broken. 5-match win streak in the first round coming in tonight for the newest sensation out of China, Chiu-Wei.
Nice sprawl by Chiu-Wei as he's able to stop the takedown and land a little bit of knees to the head of Danny Kingad for his trouble.
Danny Kingad has only ever lost one decision in his career. And that was last time out against the greatest of all time, Demetrious Johnson in Tokyo.
You hear the crowd starting to get behind Danny Kingad. That's got to pump him up a little bit when he hears his name echoing through this massive arena. It's only got to spur him on, give him that little bit of extra juice here in the third and final round.
Last 7 wins for Kingad by decision. Last stoppage win back in December 2016. It was against Eugene Takiro, an armbar in the first round. Only 2 first round finishes for Kingad. Previous to Takiro, he defeated Muhammad Haidar by TKO in the first in 2 minutes 20. He's become a decision specialist. He'd say he'd like to finish Chiu-Wei tonight. And even if he doesn't, he'll be happy to get a win. Chiu-Wei now has 3 minutes and 5 to solve the riddle of Danny Kingad.
This has been a better round for Chiu-Wei. You know, you can see Danny Kingad is starting to kind of lean on what he's, the lead that he's built a little bit, but he's got to be careful. He cannot allow Chiu-Wei to work his way back into this match. As he's on top right now, if he's able to do something big, if he's able to, you know, get a near knockdown, get a close submission, do something, you know, that really gets the judge's attention. Looks like it could have been a possible headbutt there. Olivier Cost is warning him.
headbutt,
is
headbutt.
Indeed a warning for yeah, here, a head here, clash here. There, and from a referee, Olivia Gost.
I think when Chiewe was on top, he just got a little bit overzealous inside the half guard here of Danny Kingad. Let's take a look. Yeah, that's a headbutt. Not much, just a little bit of a touch with the side of the head. Now you can drive your head into your opponent, but you're not able to kind of pull back and slam your face into their head.
Okay, Mitch, let's play coach for a moment. It is all for sure way to do with not very long remaining in the third and final round. What are you telling me?
I'd like to see Chiewe step into those leg kicks and start throwing that right hand. He's doing a good job of avoiding the takedown attempts of Danny Kingad, but I want to see him land some heat with those hands. Yeah, that was kind of a headbutt. I think it was, you know, unintentional. I don't think he really maliciously tried to attack Danny Kingad with the headbutt, but it was pretty clear. Good call by Olivier Cost to stand him back up, take away the advantage position from Chiewe. Let's see what Chiewe listens to me and does. Starts throwing that right hand.
Both men start aggressively. And Chiewe ties up Kingad, backs him against the wall. Both men train knee. There's a shoulder bump from Chiewe. Looking for a takedown. Kingad won't go there. Corks up the inside thigh. Another shoulder bump there from Chiewe. Kingad over, hooking the left arm of the Chinese athlete. Crowd right behind Danny Kingad. They are sold down here in Manila. They went nuts when Kingad came out. Wakeful for Lion comes out in our next match, folks, against Peter Bouts. That is going to be a tough contest for Liang, the megastar of the Philippines martial arts world.
So Chiewe's got to do something from this position. He's got a dominant position with the double underhooks. I'd like to see him change levels, drop down and attack the legs, not just stand there and try to bump him with his shoulder.
1 minute 35. Looks for a takedown and Kingad gets it. Chiewe back to his feet.
Beautiful change of levels there, Archie.
Oh, Chiewe hugs the back!
But Chiewe's got that choke in. Might be a little bit...
Oh, Kingad, too easy! Too slick! Too amazing! Overhooks the right arm now. 1:15 remains, Dragon.
Much better last five minutes for Chiewe. He's starting to find his groove. He's starting to win a lot of these grappling exchanges. As the crowd explodes from Danny Kingad, trying to push him on in the final 60 seconds.
1 minute left. Kingad did have a world title tilt many moons ago against Adriana Moraes. Was beaten in one round. But that tilt came way too early in Danny Kingad's career. Moraes is still the champion. Now Kingad would love another bite at Moraes. Would love another shot at Demetrious Johnson too. Will he kick off 2020 with a win? We'll find out in about 25 seconds time. Done!
That might have been a knee to the back of the head there from Chiewe. You are able to knee a grounded opponent, but you cannot knee to the back of the head. You have to touch the ears if you're going to throw it to the back of the head like that. It's like, imagine a mohawk. That's kind of the area that is, you know, off limits. No fly zone with the mohawk right there. And that's where Chiewe threw that knee. Let's take a look at it again. You can see him. You can see clearly Kingad was covered up, trying to protect the back of his head. And that's when Chiewe threw that knee.
Good call there from the best of the biz, the boss, Olivia Cost. So some recovery time here for Danny Kingad. Illegal knee there from Chiewe. A strong portion from Olivia Cost.
Yes,
the illegal
yes.
Headbutt earlier, the illegal knee from Chiewe. Let's have another look here. Hits the zone that, as Mitch just explained, you cannot hit. Back of the head, no doubt about it. Good call there from Olivia Cost.
Yeah, you can see that an athlete is allowed up to 5 minutes of recovery time. Now, since we are past the halfway point, if this match was to be stopped, we would go to the judges' scorecards. But I do believe that Danny Kingad, he seems okay.
think he's just kind of making sure everything is clear and he's ready to go.
We are going to recommence in the third and final round of this flyweight contest. The Philippines versus China, Danny Kingad and Xiaowei. Xiaowei bows in apology. Pretty back kick from Kingad, was hoping to find the heel to the liver. Xiaowei backs him up with the right hand. Sprawls out now the Chinese, I think, tries to lock in a choke in the dying stages. A desperate attempt here from Xiaowei, but it's not going to happen. Knees come from the King, Danny Kingad, and the bout is over. Xiaowei pumps his fist in the air, does a lap of honour, believes he's won this one. Folks, wherever you're watching, let us know how you scored it on Twitter, on Facebook, on the YouTube chat, on Instagram at ONE Championship. You have it for Kingad, you have it for Xiaowei. Xiaowei, fist raised, totally 100% believes he has won here.
You can just see that the lead that Kingad built up in the first couple rounds with the leg kicks, landing over and over, winning a lot of the grappling exchanges. I don't think Xiaowei did enough in the last five to kind of combat the lead that Danny Kingad built up over the first 10 minutes.
Okay, let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Vice President Hotels and Food and Beverage of City of Dreams, Manila, Mr. Michael Zaber. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the